Number 10, 6'6", senior forward, Tristan Harper.
Back.
Number 15, 6'5",
it's a new era in Kansas City basketball here at a somewhat packed swing grass. Seven and two, Kansas City, Missouri. Thanks for joining us today on RooRadio. I'm Cristian Martinez. With me is Jackson. After going 19-11 last season, the Roos went through major changes, starting with the arrival of Coach Marvin Menzies, who returns from a two-year hiatus. All four players returned from last season. You'll see many new faces on the court today. As the players start coming out, Jackson, tell me what you're excited about.
Anderson looks inside, sends it out, and they're moving the ball nicely.
Oh, beautiful Euro. Justin gets to convert, and Langston with the ball. What a beautiful Euro.
And then they're going down the court. They pass it, and it's a foul on Langston.
Charge.
The charge.
So how about that? The guard, Anderson Kopp, drawing the charge in transition. Oh, don't see that all the time, but a great defensive play by him.
Yeah. It's the first team foul. He's going to take the ball out.
And so far for the Roos, few defensive possessions. They've really looked locked in. They've looked focused. They've had good assignments. And even in transition there, just good communication.
That's a great job by the Roos. As Raquandis takes the ball, sends it down to Shamari. And again, they got to slow down, take their time. Last year, they were having issues with turnovers and just bringing the ball in. As Raquandis shoots it, looks like it's a foul.
Yeah, and that'll send him to the line for two. And that was something we were talking about the other day, Cristian, when we were previewing this matchup, was UMKC needs to get into the paint and force the issue. Yes, they've got great shooters, but they also need to get inside and force the issue, get Langston in a little bit of foul trouble.
No, when I was talking to Raekwon this open media day, he was excited to be here in Kansas City. Excited mostly for the fans as well, you know. As a man who, you know, he comes from Minnesota. Sorry, brain fart. He comes in from Minnesota, a small town, and when we were talking about the transition from Minnesota to Kansas City, he said it's not that different. As he hits the second shot, it's going to be 4-0, 18:27 left.
UMKC would like to improve at the free throw line this year from a year ago. Weren't terrible a year ago from that part, but definitely some room for improvement. There they go, 1-2. They're going for
it. KRoo turns it over, and then KRoo turned it over, and Cortez misses, and it's a foul. Oh, it's a foul on the roof.
Yeah, that'll be a foul on Cobb. He went up trying to come from behind and hit that ball out, trying to get a block. Got a little bit of arm. That'll send Langston to the line for the first time tonight.
And shooting at the line is Anthony White, the guard from Philadelphia. Looks like he's a senior. Someone Langston's going to look forward to using this year as he misses the first free throw.
Yeah, Anthony White, you talk about a senior transfer here. He actually dropped 22 points in Langston's opener last week. So another guy on that team that can really put the ball through the hoop. Roos have to be on their game stopping him.
Hits the second shot, so it's 4-1. Mukemba's gonna take out the ball. Mukemba, excited to be here as well. Got to talk to him for a little bit. And again, it's just a lot of these newcomers are excited to play. As Shamari has the ball, he's able to send it out, next it to the Anderson, send it to Raekwondas. And it's inside and it looks like it's a foul.
Yeah,
it's
gonna be a non-shooting foul there.
Perfect. All right, we'll take it out from the baseline. See if they can find an open man. Sends it to Anderson. Anderson fakes it. He takes a shot and he misses.
Man, not a great shot, but a beautiful head fake from Anderson. And more times than not, he's going to connect on that.
And then it was AJ Rainey with the rebound. Senior guard sends it back to Rainey. Rainey looking to facilitate this offense. And as we look at the Roos defense, they're really clamping on this team.
Yeah, excellent defense so far from the Roos, giving them nothing easy.
Rainey with the ball. He shoots, and he misses, but Langston with the rebound, and they put it back.
And that'll give the Roos offensive rebounds are one of the toughest things to overcome in basketball. Just can't allow for something like that to happen to the Roos.
That was Tristan Harper with the putback. And as the Roos are looking to make another shot here to kind of extend their lead, and then you see Mitchell facilitating, and he pushes inside.
Beautiful.
And it's a slam!
And let me tell you, Christian, that is what a passer's guy does. He could have forced the issue and tried to go up and draw a foul, but he draws all that attention, passes it down low for the slam.
And that was Ngondu with the slam dunk to start it off. It's 6-3, 16:50 left in the first half. As AJ Rainey's looking to make a basket, and it's a foul on the Roos.
Yeah, tough foul there. It's hard to stay in front of some of the guys like that. Very quick, nice hesitation move. That'll get him two shots in the free throw line.
All right, and we're going to go back in the free throw line. 1-2. See what they can do here. Again, the Roos need to extend their lead.
And this is AJ Rainey at the line, a guy, senior transfer from Nichols last year. Scored 4 points and had an assist in his debut.
Watching this Roos team, they're doing a really good job on defense, something that Coach Menzies really is trying to push this year.
Well, look, whenever you're in a league where offense becomes so crazy good, so many skillful players, even the bigs are really good now, as you can ask on the second, you've got to hone in defensively and try and force the issue.
Right, and then here comes the Roos. They're looking to put some more points again. Sends it to Anderson. And that's a turnover as Langston pushing down the court and they score with ease.
Yeah,
just 7-6.
Demonte Brown there taking it coast to coast.
All right.
7-6 right now. Langston on top of Kansas City here early.
And they push and it's a foul. Looks like it's a
charge. It's going to be a charge. So We've seen a few charges now, both on each team. Some very quality defense in the paint by both.
Langston has the ball now.
Get Langston to inbound.
Coming in is number 44. That's Sharif Knox, forward, sophomore forward from Philly. And there you go. The Roos need to keep pressing.
Yeah, Randy coming up the court. He's been a good facilitator so far tonight.
And there's Rainey with the ball again. And he's continuing to facilitate this Langston offense as he pushes it inside. And it's nice defense by the Roos, and Anderson has the ball.
Here's Nelson three.
And just a close. But Raquandis Mitchell with the rebound. Great play. Great IQ play by Raquandis Mitchell.
Excellent box out in the paint by him. Mitchell goes up strong, gets the Roos back up in front.
And that was Tyler Andrews with the shot. But great job by Raquandis to pick that up and just make the shot.
Absolutely, just muscled through there.
All right, Anthony White hits it down to Rainey. Gets a screen, tries to take a shot, and it's down to Cedric Rowland. Rowland's trying to push inside.
And they're gonna hit him with a travel there. Double-teamed, and we're gonna get to our first immediate timeout. 8-7, Kansas City up here early. Cristian, what have been your early impressions of what you've seen on both ends of the court?
Again, as you watch this Roos team, they're playing really physical. You know, they're taking some shots outside. They're really doing a really good job inside the paint. You know, you just gotta keep working on that. Keep just punishing that offense and defense.
They've done a fantastic job, in my opinion, on the defensive side. Now, they might have given up 7 points. Might not make Menzies too thrilled here early in the first 5 minutes. But in my opinion, they've been very aggressive. They've been very smart with the way they've defended the ball. Great switching. Guys are coming in and helping when there's a mismatch. That's the type of stuff that you want to see whenever you are just starting a season. When you're already communicating well, that's a huge advantage this early in the year.
And again, sitting down with Coach Menzies, there's a lot of talk about him coming to Kansas City, and he said that he bought a house. He didn't rent. He didn't do anything like that. He bought a house. He plans to stay in Kansas City for a very long time.
Yeah, I mean, this is where he wants to finish his career. He made that very obvious. He made that very evident whenever he had his media day press conference. So, you know, trying to build a culture here again. It's game one of his era, right? We mentioned that. It's not going to be picture perfect yet. It's November. Nobody's 100% yet. But just getting out there, getting to see what some of the guys look like. So far, been a good first 5 minutes for both squads, I'd say.
Yeah, again, great couple minutes for both teams. But again, the Roos just doing a really good job on defense, not letting up easy points. And, you know, again, on offense, they just got to make those threes. But other than that, love it when I see from this team.
Yeah, and like we talked about, the freaking length, right? Obviously, it's tremendous length out here. Langston hasn't gotten really any open threes because of how quickly the Roos are closing out and how big they are on the defensive side of the ball.
Come out of the media break. We'll see who's on the...
It'll be back. Kansas City ball inbounding.
Exactly. Now they're going to take it out. That's going to be Tyler Andrews taking the ball out, sending it to Raquandis. Again, Raquandis making a difference early. He sends it down to Andrews. Passes it to Shamari. And Anderson, who's looking to be a key veteran here for the Roos. Looking to make a difference here. As Raquandis makes a shot and he makes it in. Great play by Raquandis. What a great shot.
Creating your own shot. It's a big deal in basketball. That separates a good player from a great. Can you create your own open looks? Great job there getting the, I guess they'll call it a long two.
Yeah, long two indeed. And as looks like Toru sent a pass and it went out of bounds. Now it's back to the Roos. Andrews again going to take it out, and Raquandis is going to take that ball and try to make another shot again to extend this lead. It's 10-7, 14:39 left. Sends it down to Shamari on the outside. And as they keep passing, Anderson looking to try to make a play. fade away, and he makes it. Oh my God, what a turnaround shot by Anderson.
Now remember, Cristian, earlier when he missed that shot, I said great head fake. I know he missed the shot, but you'll take that every time. That's exactly what I meant. Give it right back to him, another great head fake. Like you noted, great turnaround, and he's a shooter. He's not gonna miss that one twice.
Oh man, he, again, talking to Anderson, and he guess it's a foul.
Offensive foul, legal screen.
Oh my God, there you go, Roos. Hopefully they'll take advantage of that foul, but again, talking to Anderson, he's had a pretty specific workout regimen this year, trying to work on his physicality and just his overall offense and defense.
Yeah, and what I would say is that, you know, I talked to Anderson, he used to be a tennis player, and he still likes to do that to keep himself conditioned, just finding ways to get your body in the best shape for the season.
And then you're going to send the ball out, Andrews has it. Anderson tries to take a shot, and it looks like it's a foul, and slow to get up. Got it. Took a shot in the ribs. Glad to see he's okay. And we're gonna take the ball. It's gonna be Allen, a returner. He was one of the key players from Coach Donlin's era here in Kansas City. And again, when Anderson's out, looks like Precious Huzaru is in from Speyer, Germany. He's has a twin that plays on the team as well, which is gonna be pretty big, you know, having a twin playing. And Andrew sends it down, throws it inside, and it's a foul.
If there's one thing that I can tell for sure so far with about 8 minutes into this season, Cristian, is how unselfish the Roos play offensively. There's so many times where they could force a shot, but they're giving it up to the next guy. And it's creating good looks, and it's creating fouls.
Looks like Ngandu gonna take some free throws here. And again, Ngandu, he's a new guy, freshman from, what is it, Lubumbashi, Seton Hall. He was in Seton Hall before he came here, came to Kansas City. So, again, Coach Menzies really focusing on freshmen, making this team a lot younger than last year.
Absolutely. I mean, I don't know if we said this number exactly, but there are 11 freshmen on this roster, so very young.
And then Langston with the miss. And it's back to the Roos, and they pass it back to Langston. A couple turnovers. And it looks like it's going to be another foul. It's going to be a push foul, I believe. It's going to be Langston's ball. Tristan Harper's going to take it out. Four, senior four from Columbus. He's going to pass it back to Toru. Toru looking to find an open man. Send it back to Sharif Knox. Then it's Anthony White, back to Toru, and then it's going to be a shot for DeMonte Brown. It's a miss, and a great job by Andrews on the rebound. Mitchell sends it down to Ngandu, and then Andrews with the shot in the three and just barely misses as the Langston Lions with the rebound.
Yeah, a good possession for Kansas City. I would have liked them to see an attack after the long pass. The dribble out, you know, you lose a little bit of aggressiveness, but overall, not a bad possession, just got to hit that shot.
14-7 lead for the Roos, less than 12 minutes left, or about less than 13 minutes left, my apologies. 1 second, there's another foul. It's foul on Shamar. It's a personal foul.
And then I'll send him to the line for two. We're been a little bit of a scoring drought right now for Langston. A 6-0 run for Kansas City real quick. Langston's going to try and end that here at the Cherry Stripe.
Sharif Knox, forward, sophomore forward from Philadelphia. He's going to take some shots. Again.
It's that first one.
Yeah, it's that first one. And again, you know, talking to Menzies, you're, as you can hear from us, you know, they're playing some really physical defense, and that's seems like we need that in order to kind of hop onto the next level in the Summit League, because especially with so many teams like South Dakota State, we're just offensive juggernauts. You know, you need some defense to kind of cancel that out.
So the second one rims out.
All right, Rekondas with the ball, sends it outside to Shamari. Rekondas with the ball again. There goes Zidaru.
Passing it around the wing here, not much there.
Andrews with the ball, sends it out to Mitchell. Mitchell trying to push it in, shoots, and scores.
Beautiful move. Beautiful flop there from Langston. They did not get that called. I know that the bench was begging for it. Leads to a wide open jumper. Roos up eight.
Raekwondas is really making a difference here early, kind of leading the Roos here today in points. Hope to see more of that later on in the first half. As Langston has the ball, they're gonna send it down to Toru. Toru makes a pass. It's a missed shot from Tristan Harper.
And those are the types of shots Langston will have to hit tonight if they want any chance of pulling off the upset. There's an offensive foul by the Roos.
Now Raekwondas Mitchell looks like it's a he pushed the defender there a little bit too hard, huh?
Yeah, just a little bit too hard, and after that, carry could have been called either way. And we have another media timeout. So 16-8 Roos here, 11:41 left in the opening half. Feels like Kansas City's been in control of this game so far.
Yeah, you're not wrong. And again, just watching this team, they're really relying on Raekwondas' play. So we'll see if he can keep going. Looks like he scored 10 points already in the first half. Again, you know, I was talking to Raekwondas, and he was telling me he's ready to play. I asked him what was the one thing he was excited about this year, and he said, I just want to play. He's ready to get on that court.
Now get this. So how hot he is tonight, right? He's 3 from 3 for 2, 1 from 1 from deep. His only miss tonight has come from a free throw. It's just crazy how that works. 10 points for him, though. You're right, he's shooting 100% from the field, has 3 rebounds. It's just been a force tonight. He's been clearly the best player on the board so far.
And then Ngandu, second in points with 4. Again, he's a physical presence and also just doing a really good job at the free throw line.
And the biggest difference is Kansas City right now shooting 54.1% from the field, compared to Langston only shooting 28.6% from the field.
And that's a
big disparity.
As I look here, you know, Langston just got to work on those turnovers. Toru Dean and Anthony White with 2 apiece. And there's 3 players with a turnover as well. You know, they got to clean that up if they want to come back from a 16-8 deficit.
And I'll tell you the other thing. I think both teams need to focus more on getting to the rack and scoring in the paint. Combined right now, these two teams are 1 of 7 from downtown, not shooting it good on either side. Now that's subject to change. There's a lot of shooters on this court, but when you're struggling from deep, try and get some easy ones down low and get some momentum, and then try and hit some free throws.
Now let's see who's on the court. I see someone familiar, Sam Martin, returning from last year. A defensive presence in dominant squad. And it looks like the Idiaru twins are on the court. Both Precious and Promise. And then Anderson Kopp there as well. And then last but not least, we got Mukemba.
Langston inbounds the ball after the turnover and after the timeout.
And that's a shot from, that was a missed shot from Toru Dean, but it looks like there's another foul.
Yeah,
Mitch,
air ball from 3. But during the play, Sam Martin, who just came in the game with an off-ball foul.
And again, sometimes it's great to be physical on defense, but sometimes being too physical can cause some fouls.
There's 100% a happy medium between it, and it's a very tough happy medium. But you know, the great teams find that.
All right, they're gonna take some shots here. Tristan Harper hits the first one. And 16-9 with 11:26 left. Your Roos still lead.
And you see Sam Martin kind of going up to one of the officials, kind of saying, man, what do you want me to do? He's a bigger guy. I'm trying to box him out. I'm trying my best as he hits the second.
Yeah, again, it's just being physical. That's kind of the...
And it's tough when you're a guy like Sam Martin, who's one of the smaller guys on the court. Being physical is tougher.
Ooh, and the Roos almost turned the ball over, and they send it to Anderson. Anderson shoots, and he just misses.
He's not going to miss that one very often. Wide open look for Kopp, just couldn't get it to fall.
And A.J. Rainey with the rebound as he brings it up. He sends it out to Tristan Harper. Tries to move around, and he's going to push it in, and it's another foul.
Tough for the Roos there. They're playing pretty solid defense. Again, just got to be a little cleaner right there at the end of the play, and that becomes just a missed shot and great defense.
That's a foul on Precious Idiaru, the freshman forward from Spire, Germany. Again, he has a twin brother playing on the team as well. Looks like there's a lot of family members playing here, you know? I don't think we've ever had a pair of twins play here, so I'm excited.
First free throw goes in for Langston.
And then they're going to try to make their second shot here. Again, 16-11, less than 11 minutes to go. And he hits the second one.
And you know, after struggling from the first few attempts at the free throw line, Langston now's gotten 4-for-4 in their last few trips to the line. Big deal when you're trying to pull off an upset like this.
Sam Martin looking to facilitate this offense now. Sends it to Idaru. And it's a turnover by the Roos.
And just a careless turnover there. Those are the things that are going to drive Coach Menzies crazy. Just miscommunication. Like, again, though, we said it is the first game of the season. Those things will happen. But you'd love to see that cleaned up.
Looks like they took out Precious out and is Shamari Allen.
And one thing that should be noted tonight, Cristian, is since this is an exhibition game, Menzies might experiment a little more with his lineup. Just see what everybody adds to this team.
And there goes the Otherton promise. Anderson playing good defense. And it's a turnover by Langston. And it's a pass to Sam. Sam pushes it into Shamari. Sends it to Anderson. Anderson shoots the three. And he makes the shot. What a great play by this Roos offense.
Shoot, man. Banging it from downtown. Sweet stroke. 19-12 Roos. Langston forced to call a timeout. Just an absolutely beautiful possession there for Kansas City.
And it was just great passing overall, you know. And again, it's passing from those returners. That chemistry, you're hoping to see that chemistry develop over time with the entire team, but you can clearly see that the returners really still have that flow from last year.
And I'll say this, Christian, when it pertains to shooting with Anderson Kopp, I sound like a broken record here, but there's not many guys better in the Kansas City metro area and hitting that deep three than him. He got to showcase that last year at Missouri, put up a lot of big shots, and here tonight already hit a couple triples.
Come out from a timeout. On the court, Sam Martin playing guard. Looks like we still got on the court Mukeba, and we still got Promise Idaru, Anderson Coppin as well, and Shamari Allen. Looks like they didn't make any changes before the timeout.
Yeah, just gather the guys around saying, look, we cannot leave the Roos open from three like we just did there.
And here's Langston with the ball. He's going to send it out to Anthony White. Pass to Toru, and it's a foul on Langston.
Appears to be a foul on Langston, yes.
Offensive foul.
Legal screen, maybe a push. Couldn't get exactly where that was. But either way, it's going back to Kansas City with 10:08 to go in the first half.
Mukemba's going to take the ball out and send it to Anderson. Not Anderson, my apologies. It's going to be Sam Martin. Looks like there's a substitution as well. Sent Promise out, and in is Jeff Nwabudu. And then look at Shamari sending a pass inside, and it's just a miss, and they're trying to put the shot in, but they two missed shots.
Good look, good opportunity, just couldn't get it to fall.
All right, AJ Rania back again with the ball. Sends it to Cedric Rowland, and back to number four, number 10, Tristan. Looking to try to pass the ball around, and then Rainey again. And he's going to get a screen. Keeps moving around, and he's going to turn the ball over. Anderson with the ball. Sam has it. Sam running down the court, makes a pass, and it's in. What a play.
Beautiful pass from Holmes. No-look pass from Sam Martin there.
Straight no-look to Ngandu for the easy layup.
He had his hands up before the play was even over. He knew. Right as he passed that, they're going to get an easy two.
Okay, Mukemba playing defense now. Ooh, and it's almost a block, and it's a steal. Mukemba with the steal. And they're going to pass it, and it looks like it's a turnover by your Roos. And there's another. It's chaos on the court. And absolutely. Anderson with the ball.
Chaos.
And it's pure chaos going on right now.
Triple.
And it's a Mukemba with the shot.
Bang from downtown.
It is straight chaos on the court. And Mukemba Jr. hits the shot at the three-point line. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, now the Roos have gotten hot from three. That's something Langston's going to have to try and limit as much as they can, because Kansas City just flamethrowers from behind the arc right now.
And now it's 24-12 with less than 9 minutes left. You got a 12-point lead, you know?
They can switch just like that. This was a contested game, right? 16-12, felt like anybody's game, and now Kansas City goes on a run. We're going to see if Langston can respond with one of their own.
And again, it's just those three-point shots are key, especially to extend that lead as I'm looking here. Again, Raquan Smith with three rebounds. You got Andrews with two. Anderson Cobb with Kemba. And Gondu with a rebound each. But again, on offense, they're just doing an excellent job just producing.
And you talk about it from downtown. 3-7 from the Roos, 0-4 from Langston. It's been a big difference to this point. Also, just from the field in general, Kansas City shooting about 53%, Langston 22%.
And I see here for the three-point percentage, they're almost at 50. They're at 42.9.
Absolutely, and that's a huge key. Kansas City been doing a good job of selectively taking their threes, right? They're not just throwing them up. Not everyone can be Steph Curry, right? They understand that. They're trying to get the best looks. And so far, they've gotten some very solid looks. Even the misses from downtown, Cristian, have been good looks.
Yeah, and again, and also something that's impressing me is the passing. Even though there are some turnovers, they're making good passes inside to get those shots that they need to extend the lead.
Unselfish basketball, man. You love to see it. Those Spurs teams of the 2000s and early 2010s, where that's all they would do, they'd pass about 20 times with possession, right? That's the type of basketball that's team-winning basketball. Kansas City's done a great job so far with that.
It looks like Tristan Harper's leading the way in points. You know, that's a guy you want to stop because he's just doing it all around. He's going inside, pushing from the outside, free throw line.
Exactly. You mentioned free throw line. 4 of the 6 points have come from the line, so that's a big deal. But they, you know, got to be a little careful there, not sending him to the line, because when he gets there, he's 100% so far from the charity stripe.
Looks like Knox is going to take the ball out. He's going to send that out to Dean. And again, it's just the Roos got to keep going. They got to keep going. Keep getting those points so we can extend this lead before halftime.
Absolutely, Cristian, as we inbound the ball and we're ready for play here again.
All right, Dean with the ball. He's looking to move it around. Sends it to Mitchell. Sends it to Tristan. And they're just passing the ball around, trying to confuse this Roos defense.
Good movement. Very good movement out of
Tristan
time.
Harper with the ball, pushes it in, and he misses.
Got to make that.
Kemba with the rebound, and then Shamari Allen passing it down, and it's a turnover.
That's very good help defense there. That probably would have been an easy deuce without it.
Ngandu was trying to get the ball, but he just couldn't hang on.
Nice screen there on Cobb.
Oh, great defense by Anderson Cobb with the putting the hand out and helping out with that steal.
Right, as I said, you know, great screen on him. Cobb read it. He just immediately didn't try and fight through the screen, just turned around, got ready for the pass, stole it.
Now the Roos need to count out. Oh my goodness, what a pass by Shamari Allen to number 23, Kemba Jr. Great play by the Roos.
Able to put that up and under. Beautiful find. Been a theme tonight for the Roos. Excellent passing.
Man, I just loving this passing. Again, with Langston with the ball. They're trying to push it in. That's Knox trying to shoot, and it's a miss. What a great block by Ngandu as the Roos are pushing it down, and Shamari makes it, and it's a foul on Langston. Let's see if he can make an and one.
Yeah, a chance for a three-point play here. The Roos have been dynamic out in transition. The block leads to a transition bucket that has a chance to be a three-point play. 28-12, Roos. Man, unbelievable.
Yeah, and again, it's just those passes are just crazy. It's just amazing to see this team playing like this. They're playing with such energy as it's 28-12, 7:36 left on the clock.
Yeah, in this first half, and there's a lot of infectious energy, like you mentioned. That block, that gets the guys caught. That gets those guys ready to go down the court. All the adrenaline that gives you, and get a bucket, and that's exactly what they did. Langston right now, not getting good shots, getting slow turnovers. The Roos are just taking advantage.
You're seeing a lot of minutes from guys like Shamari Allen and Ngandu and Anderson Cobb. All three of them over 10 minutes. Meanwhile, you got guys like Raquandis Mitchell and Kemba, 8 minutes each. And here it looks like guys like Andrews and Sam Martin and the Aru twins playing less than 5 minutes, but they're making a big difference nonetheless here.
Yeah, big difference there, like mentioned. Kansas City got a pretty good lead right now. This timeout, I'm sure Menzies is just saying, hey, keep this pace. This pace is exactly what we want to look like. On the other level, if you're Langston, what are you saying to your guys right now? You're taking themselves a pretty big
game. They got it. Again, Langston just got to play better defense if they want to stop this hot fire Roos offense. I mean, you got to call the firefighters at some point, right?
It's easier said than done, Chris. Putting this fire out is not going to be easy at all.
Hey, look, fair enough, man. I mean, what can you do? You just can't stop them. You can't stop them.
You know, it's really hard whenever you commit turnovers to get back in transition. That's something that a lot of teams struggle with. Something Kansas City struggled with earlier in this game. You just got to limit the turnovers. And also, you know, you think about blocks, right? That block that Kansas City just had, they turn it into offense. You've got to respond immediately to your Langston. If there's a block, get back and defend.
Let me read you a stat.
Read it to me, buddy.
The Roos have the biggest lead with 16. There have only been two lead changes. Looks like Lions had the lead first, and then the Roos have carried ever since. See, again, speaks a lot about the offense overall.
Yeah, and 16 is a point that Langston has to try and get this to within 10 by halftime or less. Because if they continue to let this lead, this game has the potential to be out of hand by the half.
As Allen will go to the free throw line here to try and complete the three-point play.
And he does, but they call a
flat. Line violation.
Oh, man, does he?
Left a little early.
Oh, brother, that's
the
not.
Free throw will not count Langston's ball.
Langston looks like it's Toru Dean again. Sends it down to Cedric Rowland. And again, they're Langston just trying to pass the ball around. Sends it down to Knox. And it's back to Dean. The Lions are just trying to get the ball, and it's a potential steal. Shamari just flies out.
Great play by him getting a hand on that. Wasn't able to keep it in bounds, but nonetheless, a very athletic play there. The shot clock's at 11 for Langston. They're going to have to get into their offense a little quickly.
He has those flash instincts, man. He was flying.
Well, I mean, he was. I mean, that's like a free safety in football. They get there before you can blink.
Oh, man. And again, it looks like Andrews is in. As Langston tries to make a shot, and it just hits the side of the rim.
And a great box out from Martin there. Excellent job on a bigger defender.
And here goes Tyler Andrews again. Sends it to Anderson. Anderson, again, a veteran trying to make a difference here. And then Andrews sends it to Shamari. Shamari passes it to Anderson. Kopp with the three, and he makes it! There you go.
Kopp's gonna pop. I mean, what are you gonna say?
One of the best three-point shooters on the Roos team last year.
Pop is gonna pop, man. There's nothing you can do about it. He's getting those types of looks. He's gonna nail them. 31-12 Roos. Offensive foul on Langston.
Langston just getting all these offensive fouls. They're just racking him up. That's crazy.
Not a ton of offensive fouls. Langston can't be happy.
But if you're the Roos, you gotta be really happy with that.
You gotta be thrilled with the shooting performance, and you gotta be thrilled with the defensive effort.
All right, and the Roos are gonna take the ball out. As we got someone new on the court, we got, what is it? Emanoli Dumu from Greece. We got the Greece man here. And I want to say his name again, Imani Dyke.
Yeah, they don't make it easiest on us this year, Cristian, with the names, right?
Oh, yeah.
but we're up for the challenge.
But he makes the pass to Shamari. And then Anderson with an open three again, and he makes it. What a three.
Say it with me. Cops. Gonna pop. Another three ball by him. 34-12 Roos.
Langston just keeps letting him get open. And now Langston's gonna try to extend, trying to close the lead gap here as they make a shot. That was 34-14.
That was a 18-0 Kansas City run that just got ended.
Oh my god, that's crazy. Well, less than 6 minutes left. A 20-point lead, and Anderson trying to push his way around.
Going to draw a foul there.
Great job by Anderson getting that foul.
Well, look, if I'm Langston's coach, I'll take fouling him over leaving him wide open for a three at this point.
Damn.
He has done so much damage in that department early on here.
Langston's just trying their best to contain Anderson now. This cop has 11 points.
3 of 4 from downtown.
Now he's a scoring leader, which is crazy.
Like I said, a lot of slashers on this team. They can get going, get scary for an opponent.
All right, he's going to take his free throws now.
First one's good.
There you go. And, you know, we both interviewed Anderson.
Yep.
And he's a man that I'm happy to see back here in Kansas City. He's the kind of guy you want as a leader.
Absolutely.
Especially for such a young team.
And you see it tonight even. He's been a leader on the defensive end and the offensive end. That steal that he got that led to a bucket, these threes that he's hitting, you know, a lot of guys want to be upperclassmen, want to be leaders, but it's a lot harder than just wanting to be. You've got to go out and be it, and so far he has been.
And now
His second one falls as well.
Much needed breather for Anderson.
And that now in for Anderson is Barber Cardiallo.
36-14, Roos lead, 5.5 minutes to go here in the opening half.
And you are listening to Roo Radio as Langston tries to make a shot. And it's another foul.
Yeah, offensive foul on Langston there. He tries to step back and shoot it, and he kicked his legs out too much. And refs have emphasized that more recently, Cristian, where as the shooter, you can't put your feet out and draw the foul. It becomes an offensive foul.
And Coach Menzies, you see him, he's like, just one of you guys get the rebound, not both of you guys. Just one of you, please, please.
But going back to the kick out on offense, I think why it's a rule now is because it can become a dangerous play, right? We've seen it happen before at a professional level where guys will kick their feet out, you know, out of three, and bad things can happen.
And Barber Cardiallo gonna make the shot here.
Like, got a free throw and he hits.
Hits that. Great job.
Not sure if they call it T there, but he did get to shoot that free throw.
Now it's the Roos balls again. And again, you see Coach Menzies, he's talking to one of his guys, it's Ngandu. And on the court for the Roos, it's Andrews there taking the ball out. And you got the Greek Freak, Ademu.
That is not a nickname that is given lightly.
I mean, you got guys, you even got a guy in Kansas City nicknamed that.
And now you have an offensive foul for the Roos, so a theme for Langston tonight. Kansas City commits one themselves there.
Nonetheless, we're going to have to see. Wait and see
comes
here.
Back into the game. Langston ball, 37-14 Roos.
Toru Dean with the ball. He's passing it around. Sends it to Demonte Brown. Demonte Brown sends it down to Tristan Harper. And then it's Toru Dean with the ball again. Again, the Langston's just trying to get something going, trying to cut this lead down. There you go, makes a shot. And it's a miss. And the Roos are just really great at the rebound today.
Yeah, great rebounding there. Good defense. It was a good look, but just couldn't get the ball.
You know, they got 11 defensive rebounds going. So
solid
again,
effort so far.
All right, Andrews with the ball. Gonna send it out to Dimu. Dimu trying to shake him off. Dimu passes it out to Andrews. Andrews back to Dimu. Again, Dimu just trying to move around, trying to go somewhere as he turns the ball over.
It'll stay with the Roos, but only four on the shot clock. They're going to have to get something up quickly.
They're going to have to, Coach Menzies is going to have to figure something out just to get the ball up. At least get some points here.
4 seconds on the shot clock. Can't sit it inbound. They get it in.
Andrews gets the ball. He's trying to make the shot, and
that's a killer. Langston commits a foul with only two on the shot clock. Just a bad foul in that situation because Kansas City was about to be forced to just throw up a shot.
10 fouls in the first half for Langston.
It's been rough on both ends for them in the foul department so far. They're going to have to clean that up going forward.
They're just going to have to clean that up, and now you see Andrews. He's going to take some free throws here. As he patiently waits, shoots, and he makes the shot. And again, you know, seeing all these different types of rotations, you gotta be excited to come in and play, especially guys like freshmen like Idiaru, and you see other guys like Diallo and even Dimu. Getting them some minutes is key, especially for this upcoming season.
Absolutely. Like we mentioned, this is an exhibition game. Doesn't go in the win-loss column, so at Coach Menzies at the second free throw is good. Coach Menzies can experiment a little bit tonight.
It's 39-14 with 4:29 left on the clock. Again, Kansas City really making an impact here early on.
Yeah, just a suffocating defense right now by the Roos. They've done a fantastic job.
Diallo is playing some great defense there as Langston tries to push it out to Tristan Harper. Harper sends it back to Demonte Brown as they make a shot and they miss. And again, Diallo, great rebound.
Fantastic box out.
As they're going to try to push it down quickly. Shamari fakes the shot, sends it to Diallo, sends it to Idaru, and he makes the three. What a play.
It is raining threes here in the Sweeney Center.
You're not wrong. Oh my goodness, I can see him now. I mean,
42-14. Is this a Chiefs game?
Is this a Chiefs game? I don't even know at this point. Again,
scoring's become pretty common in Kansas City, and the Roos have kept up with that theme here tonight.
And if I'm not mistaken, that was Precious with the shot.
Yeah, it was.
I gotta make sure how to understand who's Precious and who Promise. But there's, oh, great defense again.
With his back turned to the ball as well, that's very impressive. Dude just up, wasn't allowing any pass to get through. Even though he didn't know the ball was even coming, you always keep a hand up as we hit a timeout here.
The Roos are just smothering Langston. Langston just has no response. Again, 42-14 with 3:26 left.
In the opening half, this game was 16-12 tomorrow.
16-12, that's a crazy part. And you want to know why? It's them making threes.
And yeah, since then, Langston's only been able to put up two, just one. Shot has gone in since. It's just been fantastic on the defensive end by Kansas City, and on the offensive end, what can be said? Fantastic.
We're just going to make sure you guys know who we are. This is RooRadio. KRoo, thank you for listening to us today.
And you know, it's a new era of Kansas City basketball, right? It's also a new era of bringing it to you. This is our first game here at RooRadio. We're excited to get this kick back up. COVID, you know, things like that kind of shut it down for a little bit, but we are back, baby. We are ready to go.
And again, you know, we did this almost 10 years ago, and you know, it was Cody Tapp and Ryan Witkowski. If you know Cody Tapp.
Some people you might know.
Yeah, some people you might know. Witkowski,
you might have heard of him if you're from here.
Yeah, one guy's a producer, the other guy has his own show, and Cody Gold. So, you know, those guys were in our spots almost over 10 years ago, and now we're the next in kin, I guess.
Sounds good to me. Cristian, if you had to guess, what do you think the Roos are shooting from the field tonight so far?
I gotta say it's over like 60.
63.6%.
You see, I'm just that good, man.
63.6%. That includes 6 of 10 from downtown. Contrary, Langston still yet to hit a triple tonight.
Now that's crazy. I think that's wild.
You're not going to see many games of that big disparity between threes. 6-0 early here in the first half. But again, like we said, the Roos have slashers, even the bigs, getting involved from downtown.
Hey, you know what's crazy? You know, remember when we said Raquandis Mitchell was the leading scorer here?
Yeah.
Now it's Anderson.
Yep.
In just the matter of minutes, Anderson just becomes the leading scorer here. So.
And that'll happen when you hit three triples in a row.
Again, I'm happy to have someone like him here. Someone who can hit threes and play great defense.
Now get this, Cristian. Time with the lead tonight. Kansas City's had the lead for 15 minutes and 43 seconds this half. Langston, 40 seconds.
Oh my.
It's been a big difference. Langston,
holy moly, man.
Out of the timeout.
And then they try to make a three, and it's a foul. Got to see who is it on. Looks like it's a foul on Diallo.
And that's going to send Langston to the line for three.
Oh, man.
Three free throws here. An opportunity not to make a three for Langston, but to essentially get a three of their own.
Yeah, and that was an attempted shot by Tristan Harper. And then
and bad situational awareness there by the Roos because the shot clock was so low. I understand contesting the shot, but you've got to be careful. And Coach Menzies is talking to him right now about that.
And that's something you really kind of love about Menzies. He's so close to his players. It's just refreshing to see a coach that just really cares about his players. You can even notice that during media day, you know, and him talking about his whole team and just getting involved overall. It's just awesome.
First two free throws have been up and good. They'll get one more.
Yeah, it's Tristan Harper going to try to hit one more shot here. And on the court, it's Diallo and Shamari Allen. It looks like it's Promise Idiaru. Andrew's in as well. Oh, both twins are in.
So they go 3-for-3 from the free throw line. 42-17 coming up on about 3:20 to play in this opening period.
And then Shamari has the ball, sends it out to Idiaru. And it's Diallo with the ball. He's looking to shake it off. Andrews has it. Looking for someone on the outside, and Shamari again. And then Shamari passes it to Precious. And then it's Diallo. Again, and it's out of bounds.
They'll stay with Kansas City. Multiple attempts there for them, but just couldn't get any of them to fall. Some solid defense there from Langston.
Great defense by Langston. And now it looks like Shamari Allen going to take the ball out from the baseline. Let's see what they have in store for us.
And they'll get 20 on the shot clock here.
20 on the shot clock. And as Diallo sends it out to Precious, shoots a three, and he just misses. But Promise gets the ball back.
Jump ball.
Looks like it's a jump ball. Great job by Kansas City getting up on that ball.
Yeah, no, it was an excellent job there on the glass, and Kansas City has dominated the glass to this point.
16 rebounds for the Roos.
Yeah, 16-7.
No, I mean, 16-8 now.
It's been a big difference.
And they're just going to give the ball to... Looks like they're going to give the ball to Langston.
Yeah, Langston. Kansas City won the opening tip, so the possession arrow is with Langston.
All right, looks... And again, it looks like there's a crazy amount of turnovers. 10 turnovers by the Roos and 13 by Langston, but...
And it's something you can expect early in a season like this. Guys are not familiar with
And then there's another turnover. Shamari gets the ball, drives it in, and he just almost makes it. And Promise with the rebound and the putback. Great job by Promise Adiraru, the freshman from Germany.
So we talk about the importance of offensively rebounding the basketball. It was on display there. Two offensive rebounds in the same possession, able to get points out of it.
And then Knox has the ball, sends it to A.J. Rainey. And it looks like Toru got the ball. And now it's Cortez Mosley. And now it's Devontae Brown. Again, they're just trying to pass. Langston just trying to pass the ball around, trying to get something open. And as they drive it in, and they miss again. And never mind.
There's an offensive rebound for you from Langston.
I completely lied. They made it in. Now it's 44-19 with less than two minutes left. You're listening to Roo Radio as Andrews has the ball on the outside, passes to Shamari Allen. And then it's Promise shoots the ball, and he just misses.
Yeah, a little too short on that one, but a good look.
You got to love the effort, though.
Got to love the confidence more than the effort, even, because you want your bigs feeling like they can shoot.
Now it's DeGard Dean facilitating. Sends it to Knox. Try to get the screen. And that's to Brown. Sends it back to Rainey. That's Cortez. And they keep passing the ball around again.
Good movement here.
Got to find something. Got to find something if you're Langston.
Three on the shot clock, looking, passes.
Ooh, now it's just a
shot clock violation.
A shot clock violation by the root by Langston.
Didn't know if they were going to put a second on the clock or not there when the ball went out of bounds, but shot clock violation. We've got a minute 12 to go here in the opening half.
And now coming out is...
timeout by the Roos.
Timeout by the Roos. I guess you need a little breather after scoring 44.
Yeah, get yourself settled for the last minute here. Want to go into the half on a good note. Draw up a few possessions, get the guys in you'd like, and then head into the second half with a good lead.
And speaking of the second half, we got a halftime show coming up right here for you in less than a minute. Well, not less than a minute. Once halftime hits here, we're going to have our special guests, Zayin Barnes and Imani Dyke, in the head to halftime show here.
Those are going to be your names. If you're familiar with it, you keep up with Kansas City basketball, they'll be calling the women's games this year. Also a new era for them. Excited to see them get going. They played Pitt State this past Sunday, in their exhibition.
Again, it's in a new era in Kansas City here in the basketball. It's just an exciting time overall.
I'll tell you what, Cristian, if the new era goes like this first half, I think the fans have a lot to be excited about.
Yeah, we got a lot of, just got to be excited overall. Shamari takes the ball out, sends it to Andrews, again on the outside, and that's Ngandu, passes it to Anderson. Anderson trying to push it in, he shoots. And he, and it's a score.
And Shamari Allen gets up on the board, offensively rebounded. Folks, I know I sound like a broken record, but how you rebound on the offensive side of the ball is huge in this sport.
Again, it's just Kansas City imposing their will on Langston as they're going to make a shot, and it's a miss. And Kansas City trying to get the rebound, and it's banked to Langston, and it's Knox trying to make the dunk, and it's a block by Precious, and Precious goes down.
Yeah, hopefully he's all right. Seems to be doing okay.
Looks like he might have gotten hit in the eye.
Yeah, a little bit of a hard collision there.
But that was a great block nonetheless by...
Oh, fantastic. I don't know what Langston thought going up for a slam there when you got a big body in the paint like that. Didn't work out too well, but they were able to get the ball back, draw a foul, and they'll take two free throws here with 26.6 to go in the half.
46-19, less than 30 seconds.
First one's good for Langston, 46-20.
And on the court here for your Roos is Andrews, number 25. Precious, number 10.
And Allen just subbed out for Sam Martin, so Martin back into the game to finish off this first half for Kansas City.
And Ngandu playing
the fourth. Second free throw, good. So Langston tonight, going to take any positives out of this first half. Been very good from the free throw line.
Oh,
and there's a turnover.
That is not good as... Your Roos turn the ball over. Sam Martin gets the ball out and just instantly turns the ball over to Langston.
You see Anderson caught barking a little bit. You know, as a leader, he's saying, guys, that can't happen. We've got to get that last possession of the half. 23.6 to go here. You'd have to think Langston holds it for the last shot.
Good job by Langston, trying to take some time. Less than 20 seconds left on the clock. It's Toru Brown taking the ball out. He's taking his time, doesn't want the Roos to get any more points here. And that's Sam Martin trying to play defense. And he, Langston nice takes the shot. Last second.
7 seconds here. Martin going to come up the court.
Sam Martin has the ball looking. Anderson has the ball trying to take a shot. And he shoots and he just misses at the buzzer.
That'll take us to halftime. 26-23. Roos with the first half advantage of explosive shooting performance. We'll be back with you for the second half, but for now, let's go ahead and kick it to our halftime show.
We'll be back in just a minute. Okay.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to KRoo's RooNews Halftime Show with Zayin Barnes and Imani Dyke. First half, not looking, you know, it's kind of lopsided, 46-23. Imani, what were some of the main things that you were seeing from both teams in the first half?
I think really impressive strong showing from they're combining very well, good guard play. The only thing I would say for UKC is the turnovers. They had 11 in the first half. Langston, I'd also say the turnovers.
I agree. And then also UMKC's defense is, there's no way to get around it at this point. I mean, limiting Langston to only 23 points in the first half to their 46. And then also, like you said, looking at the turnovers, 15-11, you'd think that would be like more even than it is, you know what I mean? But it's the ability for UMKC to take over off the turnovers and convert off of them rather than, you know, turn the ball over, slow it down. One thing about UMKC, they're controlling the pace of the game. I can see that. You know, they're getting their shots, creating their shots. Langston is really having a tough time creating their own shots. I mean, most of their points coming off free throws, 13 free throws to 5 field goals, shooting 23.8% from the field. You're not going to win a game like that, right? So.
His style of basketball, very fast paced on the offensive and defensive end, and you can tell that he's really fast on defense.
Absolutely. To go off of that, going off the defensive side, the rebounds, I mean, it's not much of a rebound matchup either. Like, you know, UMKC has 20, Langston has 12. Like, it just seems like all aspects of UMKC's game right now is looking kind of, you know, unpenetrable. So I think Langston has to do a better job of slowing down the game, could try and control at their own pace, because, you know, they can't play at the same pace as UMKC, and that first half kind of showed us that. You know, it's pretty much barbecue chicken over there, as I would say. You know what I mean? So.
One thing I would say for Langston, though, a little bit of hope, I think something they can build on in this game and moving forward in the season. They are getting to the line. I mean, a lot of their points, 15 of the 23, have come to the line. So I would say keep doing what they're doing, whatever they're doing to get to the line. Keep that up, because 15 out of 20 from the line is not bad. They just got to keep pushing the pace up. Hopefully keep getting to the line, and hopefully that'll open up some shots for the shots on the ball.
Yeah. Hopefully, I mean, you know, 5 for 21 in a half. That's not, you know, you have 5 total field goals in 20 minutes. And then, like, looking at the turnover game, too, 15, 7 of those 15 coming in the first 7 minutes of the game. You really have to work on, taking care of the ball. Like, that's something that is, you know, it's game defining, if that makes sense. You know what I mean? So
yeah, for sure.
So I mean that's there's a lot of aspects that UMKC has to, I mean, that Langston has to look at if they want to come back. Right now it's kind of lopsided. Exactly. It's not impossible, but, you know.
Yeah, it's just that they have a very steep mountain to climb on. What are some keys, Zayin, to the second half of both these teams? Do you think what are some things both these teams can do a little bit better in the second half?
Well, I mean, for Langston, I want to see, you know, switching it up on defense. I mean, you're not, you know, there's too many open shots. Their UMKC's ability to create their own shots is, you know, it's outplaying Langston. Like Langston, UMKC's rotations defensively and offensively are just way too much, and Langston just seems confused. So I want to see maybe a zone. I wouldn't say a 2-3 zone necessarily, because, you know, UMKC's 6-for-11 from three. So that's not necessarily the route to go. Maybe a 3-2. Maybe a box and one, but that's another thing. If your rotations aren't working in man-to-man, if you're not able to switch off, you're probably not going to be able to do zone either.
Yeah.
On UMKC side, though, I'd say keep continuing to control the pace of the game. The only thing that they probably should do better is to take care of the ball. That's really their only flaw right now, with 11 turnovers and a half. But, I mean, other than that, they're really looking good out there. I say they're hitting their shots. They have to come out of halftime and keep attacking. How they came into this game, they have to attack.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's pretty much all Langston has been doing is attacking the rim. It's just their shots aren't falling. So, yeah. I mean, they've gotten some open looks, but UMKC's defense is just way too tight for them.
Yeah. One key, I would say also for UMKC is consistency. This is a very, very good half, very solid showing, but we do not want this to dip off in the second. I know that teams do like to start hot and get comfortable. And kind of drop off in terms of effort, in terms of
get complacent.
I think just keep staying aggressive. I think the get it to the line as many times as they did with the 15 free throws, and they're shooting up almost 90% from the line. So they are getting there, and not only getting there, but making their free throws. So I would say that that's a big positive for Langston. UMKC just really has to stay consistent, and I think they can see this one out.
Absolutely. And another thing that Langston needs to work on is converting off turnovers. Like, you're creating turnovers, 11 turnovers for UMKC. You're just not converting off of them. I mean, looking at the numbers right now, it's UMKC 24 points off turnovers to Langston's 5. So you have 11 turnovers and 5 points off those turnovers. That's not going to suffice. You know, you have to try and work at your own pace, because right now UMKC is controlling offensive and defensive pace, and that's not acceptable if you're Langston.
For sure. Langston also, I believe, has to do a better job of crashing the boards, I believe. UMKC had 8 offensive boards in the first half alone, which is pretty impressive. Langston only had 4. So if they could just put a little bit more effort in on crashing that offensive glass, it could definitely create a lot more second chance opportunities for them at the rim, for them to either create a foul and get to the line, which they've been excelling at, or to create second chance points and maybe cut this lead down a little bit in the second half.
Yep, I agree. That's pretty much all I have to say about, you know, key points of the game. I really think if UMKC can come back out and continue to control the pace, continue to play their game, and, you know, another thing I'm looking at is Anderson Cobb. Not only is his scoring ability showing right now, but also his leadership. Offensively and defensively, he's communicating with his guys, making sure everybody's, you know, on track, all the ducks are in a row. So I think if Anderson Cobb can come back out, continue to lead his team, there's no reason UMKC is going to lose. So
you can tell it's clear that this team does feed off of Cobb. Just watching this squad walker play, Cobb is a real leader. He steps on the court, you can just feel his energy and his presence, and you can feel that players in the ball club gravitate toward him. So I would say for Cobb, just keep doing what he's doing, keep being aggressive, keep being a leader, and everything else will follow. The team definitely looks like they're feeding off of his energy.
All right, well, thank you all for listening. This has been KRoo's RooNews Halftime Show. I'm Zayin Barnes here with
All right. thank you for the halftime show, guys. That was Zayin Barnes and Imani Dyke. Now we're going to talk to our sideline reporter, Marissa. Sorry about that, guys. We were trying to mic, and it was just getting way too loud here. You know, that's how energized the Sweeney Rec is. But, Marissa, again, tell me a little bit more about what you were seeing.
Yeah, no. I've seen great defense from the Roos tonight. Phenomenal plays, 46-23, off to a great start, first game of the season. Coach looks just as excited as these players are on the sidelines, and I just think we're off to a great start really here.
We're hoping to see a new game overall. What are your final thoughts overall? What are you excited about in the second half?
Final thoughts overall, I'm excited to see these other players get out there, take part, and hopefully we pull out this win.
Perfect. All right. Thank you, Marissa. We'll be back with you in a minute. All right, guys. And again, 46-23 lead. We got about less than 3 minutes left before we're back on. But here is my good friend and a fellow co-worker, Jackson Ogden. Jackson, welcome back.
What are the emotions going through you right now after such a great performance by the Roos?
Take what you thought this team was going to look like. Maybe if you're the most optimistic person on the world, and up the optimism, because wow, was that a lights out shooting half from Kansas City? Will every half be like that? No. Human wise, it'll come back down to earth. But I tell you what can be sustainable is the defensive energy. I'm loving the switches. I'm loving when I'm seeing these guys get out and run defensively and turning the defense into offense going the other way. You can tell they're well conditioned because every single time they get a stop, it's boom, Sonic the Hedgehog back down the floor.
And then let's talk about some key players sponsored by RooTV. Again, looking at Anderson Cobb, he is the difference maker here.
Yeah, absolutely. Cobb's been a huge difference maker, and you expect that out of a senior, a guy who was a big difference maker a year ago in his role, and it's just going to get even bigger this year with so many guys gone, so many new faces, but he's here, and he's, you know, talked about it, being a leader, having a bigger role, and so far, he's lived up to it, Christian. I mean, I don't know what more you could ask from a guy than 13 points, 3 threes in a first half.
Yeah, and again, you see Anderson, and Anderson is just going to have to continue to play that role of shooting threes here and there, because that's what's going to carry this Roos offense from time to time, is just making those threes.
Yeah, and, you know, absolutely. You know, I just think Kansas City overall, while they did have a great shooting half, sometimes you go cold for three. The thing that I think they will not go cold on is their aggressiveness in the paint, and like I said, their aggressiveness on defense. It's been a very impressive half. Now, if you're Langston going into this half, Christian, what do you say? What adjustments do you make if you're Langston to try and claw your way back in?
Again, if I'm Langston, I'm trying to work on defense because that's what's killing you. Defensively, you just got to do a better job. You know, when you got guys like Anderson making shots constantly, and then you got Raquanis Mitchell inside the paint, you know, shooting from the mid, showcasing his mid-range game. Mid-range game is just impressive. And then overall, it's just the Roos are too physical. Langston just has to work on.
Here we go, though.
Yeah, Langston again. Before we start the game, you got to work on getting some shots in. Got to work on the defense, and overall, just executing at a better level. And even then, fouls.
Yeah.
Got to reduce the fouls if they want to hang on at least.
Yep.
As the Roos again lead 46-23, and we're gonna start. As the Roos start with the ball.
We got Kayla.
Throws it out to Raquanis Mitchell.
Underway here in the second half. Roos with possession. Looking to expand on a great first half.
Anderson has the ball and he throws it out. And then Langston takes it in. And it's a
huge
block! What a block!
Wow, I think, let's see, ref signaled something. I believe perhaps a goaltend. Yep, a goaltend will be called there, but man.
Mukeba Jr.
What an effort there to try and get back and stop that.
And then here's Raquanis, and he's trying to jump and he loses the ball.
Yeah, sloppy start to the second half so far.
And Rainey pulling in.
Yeah, sloppy start for the Roos so far. Back-to-back turnovers leading to back-to-back buckets. They need to clean it up a little bit starting here in the second half.
46-27 with 19:20 on the clock. Anderson Kopp passes the ball, throws it out to Shamari Allen. Shamari looking, he sends it to Raquandis Mitchell. Mitchell just looking around, trying to get something going. And he sends it outside to Mukeba Jr. Mukeba moves around, and he shoots, and he hits the post. Oh, my goodness. Again, so physical. He makes the very difficult layup, and hopefully he's going to get an and one here.
Yeah, very, very tough layup to make. He went behind the back to get that, and now he's got a chance for a three-point play. He's a big guy. I mean, someone like that, when he comes down full force into the paint, you've got to just get out of the way because he is a physical force and a physical presence as he is able to hit the free throw to complete the three-point play. So a very good job by the Roos responding after a couple turnovers.
And again, Mukeba is just doing a really good job today. He's been playing some solid minutes, 9 minutes here, and he's got 5 points. Really making a difference. And then here we go.
And now let's see if the Roos defensively can start playing some better ball there. You know, they started giving up a couple of baskets in that beginning of the second half off of turnovers. Now they get set. Let's see.
Dean takes a shot, and he makes the basket.
Sometimes the bounces just go your way, Christian. That one rattled around for about 3 seconds, but went in.
And now Langston looks like he's taking our advice. They're cutting down this lead, this deficit, I should say. And Anderson looks on the outside to see Shamari. Shamari sends to Mukeba, and oh man, Langston has the ball.
The third turnover of the half, and a timeout by Marvin Menzies. He is not happy with the way his Roos have played to start this second half. I mean, we're a minute and a half in, and we've already had three turnovers by the Roos offense.
Yeah, he is scratching his head. I saw him scratching his head. He was like, man.
I mean, sometimes you get a little complacent, right? You get up big at halftime, you come out, it's hard to replicate the energy you had when you started the game. Just got to get back to the fundamentals here.
Again, it's up 19, but Kansas City needs to take advantage of this lead and just kind of close it now before it's too late, before Langston kind of claws back in and tries to make the lead smaller.
You know, there were a lot of turnovers in that first half by both sides, but Kansas City, for the most part, took care of the ball all right. To start this second half, it's just been kind of careless, just throwing the ball around. And, you know, it just comes down to we can't beat ourselves, right? If a team beats us, that's fine. We played our style of basketball. But we cannot afford to beat ourselves.
And you know what? Speaking of this Roos roster, we got a guy who is the son of a Hall of Famer.
Yes.
Abdullah Olajuwon. He's a red shirt. He won't be playing this year. But he's a guy. Now here's a guy that I'm excited for next year. When you got a player who's the son of a Hall of Famer of what do they used to call Hakeem?
Hakeem the Dream.
Hakeem the Dream. You know, again, when you got a player like that in Kansas City, it could pay dividends. And again, you know, when I was talking to Coach Menzies, he was telling me some of these players are going to be redshirt.
Yeah,
be redshirt this year. But I'm seeing a lot of great things from these guys. And
yeah.
I wonder what starting our roster is going to look like at the beginning of the season.
Yeah, and look, he said the roster has about 18 guys on it, and there's about 11 freshmen. And he said he anticipates about 6 to 7 of those freshmen will get redshirted this year, Olajuwon being one of those guys. So, you know, you just have to – it's exciting, right? But it's a developmental process. That's how college hoops typically work. You're not Kentucky. You're not Duke. You're not getting the number one player in the country. So you've just got to, you know, develop these overseas guys especially. And, you know, you got to like what you've seen from the guys who have played tonight, though.
And that's his M.O., honestly. Coach Menzies' M.O. He loves international players. Right, again, when I remember I was talking to him before he officially got hired.
Yeah.
And he was telling me, I'm going to look at the international pool, see what I can get.
Yeah.
And he's got a lot of great guys, guys from Germany, guys from Greece. And now as Langston takes out the ball, that's Dean. Dean taking it out, looking to find a guy. Sends it to A.J. Rainey, back to Dean. Sets the screen, Rainey takes the shot, and he misses. And the Roos, almost get the rebound. But that's Cedric Rowland. The ball is going out of bounds.
And again, sloppiness by the Roos. The Roos had that rebound and got it poked out. It's something that they have to get better at so far in the second half. It just hasn't looked like the same team that it was the first half. Now, it's early. It is early. We're only 2 minutes in, small sample size.
but they need to clean it up a little bit more now.
Still 49-30, 18-10 on the clock. There was some confusion there for a second on who has the ball, but it's Langston's ball. And Torreginian dribbling, moving around, finagling. Here he goes. He's trying to pull in. Sends it out, and an erratic shot, or I should say pass, leads to a Roo ball.
Yep, and there's a turnover for Langston. They struggled with that in the first half, and they're really the first key mistake for Langston in this second half right there.
Well, man, you don't, if you're Langston, you
can't afford those right now.
Yeah, you got to clean those up. And Raquanis Mitchell with the ball. Sends it to Anderson. Anderson looking to find an open man. Gets Promise out.
And they're doubling him right now.
They're
a little bit of a zone here for
you got to double him at this point. And Promise has the ball. Nice sends pass. It inside. Mukemba with the layup.
Beautiful find. Absolutely beautiful find.
That is Alan Mukemba Jr. with the layup. Showing off his hops as well.
And that's what we talked about in that first half is the passing was so selfless. And there it was again.
Ooh, and then Langston with the fadeaway. And that was number 15, Cortez Mosley. Wow, that was a good play by him.
Very nice shot by him. And what did we talk about in the first half? Good players make shots. Great players create shots. And that's what he did.
Langston clapping up on Raquanis Mitchell and Mukemba pushing it in. Sends that out to Shamari. Shamari on the outside perimeter. Raquanis takes a shot from the perimeter, and that's in and out. The Roos have the ball, and they just give it back to Langston.
Yeah, just paddling around there for the basketball. Weren't able to quite grab it.
Just so much chaos today.
There's been a few possessions where the ball just is going everywhere.
Oh, man. Gotta love college basketball, man.
And that's a double dribble
ooh,
by Langston. Man. Slipped a little bit, and when he recovered, he ended up doubling.
Ay, caramba, that is not good. Not good for Langston.
Yeah, again, you're down 51-32 right now. You can't afford those types of turnovers, especially versus a team like Kansas City, who's very good on the offensive side of the ball.
There goes Mukemba. Sends the ball up to Raquanis. Raquanis. They are just clipping off on him. They're playing better. Langston's just playing better defense this time around. But Raquanis pushes it in. He... Ooh.
Wasn't able to get it, but it will be a blocking foul. He'll go to the charity stripe for two.
There you go. Man, that almost went in, too. That could have been an and one. But
it would have been, the third and one the Roos would have had tonight. But nonetheless, going to the line for two.
You take what you can get if you're the Roos now.
You'll take a trip to the line every time.
Hey, it's 51-32, 16:29 on the clock. Raquanis Mitchell's going to take some shots. And I sat down and had some lunch with him, too. We had to plan it sub. And we were talking too, you know, again, a guy coming from Minnesota, and he said the first thing he did when he came to Kansas City is just go to hoop. He literally went to YMCA to go hoop for a bit. And again, he just shows you how dedicated he is to the game and how he's going to take a big role here in Kansas City.
And he was able to hit both free throws there, so 53-32 Roos. Here comes Langston with the ball.
A.J. Rainey. A.J. Rainey has the ball. Sends it to Anthony White. Sends it to Tristan. Sends it back to Rainey. Harper with the screen.
And great defense here by Kansas City. The movement.
And they're just clamping down too. Sheesh.
But here's
and
a good
Tristan look. Harper.
Couldn't go. Battle for the board. It's going to be
Roos ball. All right. Roos ball. Great job by the Roos. Getting that ball back.
Yeah, fantastic job by the Roos there.
All right, here we go. This Raquanis Mitchell passes the ball to Mukemba. Mukemba making a difference here in the second half, and he loses the ball. And then Langston gets the ball. A.J. Rainey. Oh, and that's
a block from behind. LeBron James, game 7-esque. Back the other way come the Roos.
And Raquanis
charge. They're going to call a charge there, so the Roos weren't able to capitalize in transition.
What a block. He's
what
showing the
chase down.
Again, the Roos are just showing off their kangaroo hops. Something you really need here in Kansas City.
Unbelievably great effort defensively. We're going to have a media timeout here. 53-32, 15:40 left in this one. Roos still a very comfortable lead, a little closer of a second half so far. But again, that's kind of how the first half went. First 5-6 minutes were pretty tight. Roos went on a run. Roos will be looking to do the same out of this timeout.
Yeah, and again, if you're the Roos, you got to keep capitalizing. It's 53-32, like you're saying. But
just got to capitalize. Keep extending that lead. I want it to be 60-32. I want it to be a 30-point lead. But again, I'm happy with what I have. And if you're a Roo right now, you got to be happy with what you're seeing from this team.
Yeah,
especially
on
offense.
There's nothing that can't be corrected, right? It's not a talent deficit. It's just right now they're making a few mental errors and they're making a few mistakes. But there's nothing that can't be corrected, and that's what has to excite you the most if you're Kansas City right now.
And as I'm looking at the points, it looks like Anderson with 13, Greg Wandis with 12, and then you got Mukemba climbing up. He's slowly making a bigger impact. Got 10 points.
You've got three Roos in double figures right now, so sprinting that ball around. And then you've got multiple other moves with some points. So, good luck to the Roos right now.
And the leader on assists today is Shamari Allen with 4. And then it looks like the Roos are just passing. They're just sharing the ball really well. Again, that's what you would want from a Roos team who can shoot from the 3-point line.
Yep. And I'm telling you, Cristian, that there are some passes, there are some plays tonight that have not counted as an official assist, but have led to a basket. And that's what you need. Not everything shows up in a box score. But I guarantee you the coaches go back and watch that film and they say, yeah, that's about just as good as an assist.
And the Roos have 28 points from turnovers.
Yeah, I mean, that's the biggest difference.
And then the Lions have only 9.
It's the biggest difference.
So the Roos are taking advantage of those turnovers. Meanwhile, 18 points from the paint for the Roos, with the Lions having 14. They're doing a really good job on the fast break with 7 points and 8 points from the bench. Again, if you can get any points from the bench, that's big, especially, yes, again, such a young roster.
But we talked about it. Kansas City's pretty deep overall, right? You know, some guys will redshirt, but the Roos have a pretty deep lineup.
Again, a very impressive lineup. Again, it's just, you've got to be excited if you're a Roo.
Absolutely. Langston will take the ball in here, and we're back in play.
And Toru Dean taking the ball out. Ooh, and Shamari gets his hand on the ball, but Langston has it again. That's Harper. That's Dean pushing it inside, and he sends it out, and it's a steal.
Good job,
Shamari,
by the
pushing it down for the fast break. Andrews with the block. Show off your hops, young man, as Andrews slams the ball down for a key dunk.
Slamming that down with authority.
With pure authority. And what a play.
Nearly another steal.
The Roo is just, oh my goodness, playing with some energy out there.
Yeah, this has been a great defensive effort so far out of that timeout. They get the steal, they go for the slam, and now here nearly another time, another pocket pick. Here's a deep three from Langston. It's no good. Rebound Roos.
And that's promise.
And here comes
Kansas
City.
Rick Wanda's pushing it inside, moves around, and
blocking
like
foul. Go to the line for two.
Good job by the Roos.
And this is what you want to see if you're Kansas City. Push the pace. Whenever you get a long rebound, whenever you get a turnover, immediately go, force the issue. Sometimes it's a slam dunk, sometimes you draw a foul, but regardless, a good result for the Roos.
Yeah, again, you just got to be happy if you're a Roo right now, because the energy's different.
Energy's here. They're ready for this game, and that's what you want to see.
All right, looks like Mitchell's going to try to get some more points.
Yeah, try and get a couple here, extend the lead a little more.
All right, he's going to... And again, Raekwon is making a big difference with 12 points. Make that 13. Got 3 fouls, but again, the points matter. It looks like Knox is coming in. Roland is out for Langston. And on the court for your Roos is Anderson Kopp, Shamari Allen, Raekwon Mitchell, Promise Idiraru, and that is Tyler Andrews. So again, a lot of... The veterans who returned are getting some good minutes in.
Mitchell hits the free throw. 57-32, Roos lead.
And you are listening to Roo Radio. This is Christian Martinez. And here is Jackson Ogden. Just want to make sure you guys know.
Hey, we're new here. New Kansas City basketball era, right?
Oh, as Langston makes a shot, that was Tristan Harper. Great job offensively
and
for them.
And here come the Roos again, pushing the pace. Not taking any time. Kopp in a little bit of trouble there. He'll pass to Allen.
And that was a... They were not in sync there.
Yeah, a little bit of... And again, young team.
Take
young
time.
Season.
Got to take your
chemistry's
time.
Chemistry's not there yet. It'll get there.
It will get there.
Growing pains. It's part of basketball.
Allen was trying to get a pass to Andrews, but just couldn't make it.
And here we go on defense. Again, Menzies really highlighting defense this year, and you can it just shows here, 57-34. As Langston tries to hitch a shot, and it's a rebound by Anderson Kopp, as he tries to push down Harper.
Now you're going to see the Roos slow it a little bit. They've been up and running the last few possessions here. They're going to try and slow something down, get into a set.
Tyler Andrews has the ball, sent it to Shamari. They're trying to push it inside. Anderson with the ball. Again, he's on fire today. Let's see if he can make some more points.
Drew the foul, nearly got the basket to go. He'll head to the line for two. And that's what you want, your guy like Kopp going to the line because he's one of your best shooters. You feel confident you can get two here at the line from him.
Yeah, let's see what they can do here. Anderson doing a really good job today, kind of facilitating, doing all the things he has to do to make a difference for the Roos.
And Kopp's first will go up and is good. Bryant in for Langston.
And again, looks like no major changes here to Roos. Looks like they're going to keep the same rotation. Looks like Precious is going to come in. He's taking a knee right now, just waiting, taking his time.
Kopp here for the second shot. And he hits them both.
Great job.
Kopp's going to sub out after those two.
And it's Precious and Promise on the court with Raquandis Mitchell, Tyler Andrews, and Shamari Allen.
59-34 Roos, 13:35 to go in this one.
All right, and LaRue's playing press defense now. Oh my.
Again, exhibition, you're trying to test some stuff out. Doesn't really matter about the score. You're trying to see how physical, how your defense works.
Tristan Harper trying to push it inside the paint. Makes the layup, and it's a foul.
Yeah, got him a little bit over the head there. You know, good defense, good attempt, but again, cleaned it up just a tad, and you get a stop there.
Now we see Ngandu getting ready. Wonder who's he going to come in for. Might come in for Tyler Andrews, but we'll see. All right, Tristan Harper on the line. Again, if you're Langston, you got to get some points up now before it's too late. You know, Tristan Harper's leading the way in points as well with 11, followed by Dean with 7, and then Rainey with 6. Looks like that's kind of their big three going forward.
First free throw is up and good for Langston.
And it looks like Promise is coming out and then is Ngandu. All right, so it's 59-35 with 13:22 on the clock. You're listening to Roo Radio. Again, Jackson, you gotta hope Langston gets some more points to at least make it competitive, but I'm not complaining.
Yeah, Harper hits the second free throw there, and here comes Kansas City down the other end.
Raquandis Mitchell gets a screen from Precious. Raquandis still with the ball, trying to make something happen. He goes down the baseline.
And foul on the baseline. That'll be called on Harper. And that's Harper's fourth personal foul. So he's going to head to the bench. Get 5 fouls. Fouls you out in college.
All right. Sam Martin coming in. Coming out is Raquandis Mitchell. All right. Sam's going to make a pass on the baseline. Hits it to Shamari, and Shamari just misses. And Langston has the ball, and that's Demonte Brown trying to push it in. And that's a block!
And it's going to be a goaltend, though. It hit the glass first. Refs are going to say that ball hit the glass and was then blocked. Regardless, a fantastic effort
by Ngandu, man. Showcasing his ability to block.
Absolutely.
Oh, and there's a screen for Sam Martin. Or
decides not to take it and passes it out.
Oh, and then Tyler Andrews trips.
It'll stay with the Roos. He's able to throw it off of a Langston defender.
And again, Sam Martin is a redshirt junior guard. Last season, he was averaging 2.7 points, almost 0.6 rebounds, and almost 1 assist per game with 10 steals. Wonder if you'll see a bigger role for him this season. And then Shamari hits the line.
Shamari, that's one that he'll want back. Wasn't able to get the hook to go. Langston with the ball.
And there you go. That's A.J. Rainey. It's going to end it to Anthony White. Send it to Knox. Rainey with the ball again. And he moves around and it's a block, but it's a foul again.
Yeah, got a little bit of the arm from behind. just wasn't able to quite get a clean block there.
And again, as I was saying, Sam Martin, you know, didn't have a big role last year for Donald's not squad, but you wonder if he's going to play a bigger role this year, especially as a return.
Yeah, you know, one of the few guys returning to this roster, you'd have to think, especially with him, you know, having another offseason as the first free throw for Langston goes. Cobb comes in.
Yeah, Dimu coming in as well for Sam and Anderson in as well. So we got a big-time scorer. We got a young man from Greece playing as Langston misses, and the Roos get an easy rebound. Dimu passes it out to Anderson. Anderson looking to go in, and that's Ngandu, and it's a foul.
Yeah, they're going to call the foul there. Thought maybe he got the ball, but ended up, refs think he got a little bit of that arm. A big presence in that paint. Hard to defend somebody like that. He'll get two shots at the line.
He's a guy that reminds me of Marvin Nesbitt last year.
Absolutely.
A guy who
very similar body.
Very similar body, very similar way of playing, you know, especially on those blocks.
First free throw is going to be off.
Misses it. And then looks like Langston making some changes as well. And on the floor for Iru is Anderson Kopp, Dimu, Ngandu, Precious Idiaru, and Tyler Andrews. Tyler Andrews getting some significant minutes here today. Again, even though it's just an exhibition game, great to see these guys get some key minutes in.
Second free throw goes. 60-39 Kansas City coming up on 12 minutes.
All right, the Roos are playing some great defense. And that's a pass that's over. Dean with the ball, shakes off his defender. It just doesn't hit the
Yeah, looking around.
And that's a shot.
It's going to be on Kansas City. Off-ball foul.
Off-ball foul, dang. That was Anthony White was attempting a shot as well, but I was negated any foul.
Media timeout here. 60-39 Roos lead. 11:54 to go in regulation. Second half, what are your thoughts so far on the way it's looked compared to that first half?
You know, I'm watching this team and they still got that energy, but I want more. I want some more. Give me a little bit more.
And to your point, Langston has outscored Kansas City in the second half. 16-14. Langston has shot 6 of 11 from the field, 54%. Just so much better in the second half from Langston than what we saw in that first half.
Now you just gotta wait and see. And as I look here, it looks like the Roos are 6 of 12 from the 3-point line, 16 of 18 on free throws, 25 rebounds and 17 turnovers. Again, Kansas City, last year they were well known for being a presence in terms of rebounds and inside the paint. It looks like it's going to carry on this year. Again, 50% from the three-point line. Got to be happy with that.
Yeah, and they've just got, like we've talked about, incredible length, but even the guys that don't have length have incredible strength, and they've been able to box out very efficiently tonight, get those boards. I've been real impressed with what I've seen on both the offensive and defensive glass.
And the Roos are 50% in the second half in the field goal percentage. In an overall game, they're 50%, 19-38. 19 shots made of 38 attempts. And again, I'm looking here. The Roos are just doing a very good job getting some points off turnovers. Gotta keep that going.
Absolutely. We get set to get back here out of the media timeout. Roos with a substantial lead.
All right, now we're back on the floor again. It's Raquandis Mitchell, Anderson Kopp, Ngandu, Precious Idiaru, and Tyler Andrews. And Langston tries to throw it out, and then Anderson with the steal. Raquandis pushes it in, and he makes the shot. What a layup.
Careless mistake and great transition offense from the Roos.
Tyler Anderson, again, showing off his length. Gets a great steal, and then Raquandis picks it up and makes the shot as Langston trying to answer.
And that's what Langston hadn't been doing in the second half. They had cleaned up on some of those silly mistakes, but right there.
And then Dean with the screen, and he shoots, and he scores. It's 41.
Yeah, 41. Really real good shot there. Anderson Kopp on him, turns around and says, good shot, gives him a high five. Even he has to admire, because he was all up in his face.
Oh, man. Tyler Andrews has the ball, sends it to Raquandis. Rukondas looking to look for a man open. Pushes it out to Precious Idoraru. Sends it to Cobb. Cobb asking for a screen. He does not get it.
Shot clock winding down here. Needs to get something going, but a turnover.
And a turnover. Anderson was trying to look for a perimeter shot there.
Anderson was, you know, anticipating a cut there. Didn't just didn't happen.
All right. The Roos are here playing good defense. Taking care of the paint. That's Anthony White. Sends it to Roland. Roland misses.
But that'll be a shooting foul on the Roos. So back to the charity stripe goes Langston.
And again, if you're Langston, you're trying to cut the deficit down at least to 20 or 10.
Yeah, Langston, you know, I would say if you're Langston by the 5-minute mark, you need to get this within 10 realistically to get back into this one. It's just hard with the way they've shot the ball from three tonight to imagine that they could come back from anything more at that point. But they have an opportunity here to cut into that lead a little bit more.
And they're 16 and 19 from the free throw line. Make that 17 and 20.
Which is very good for the college level. That is a very high mark for college basketball.
Alan Mukemba Jr. coming in. Again, that a player from Belgium. He has a twin brother playing here as well. Again, two pair of twins playing for the Roos.
Second free throw is no good, but the offensive rebound goes to Langston.
And
tough shot, no.
And Roland gets the rebound as he tries to pass it out. And that's Dean making the shot, and he misses. And that's Anthony White, and he tries to put it in, and it's
tough in. Tough finish. Real tough finish. Very well defended. Credit where it's due. Langston, great job there, and a careless pass is nearly turned over. It'll stay with the Roos, but a very dangerous pass.
And Knox was trying to get that pass to go in, but pushed it out. They knocked down the board, the whiteboard for the Roos. But nonetheless, Gandhi with the ball. Good pass. Passed it to Raekwondas. He was trying to take a shot, but he takes a pass.
And that was a very good out-of-bounds play. Just wasn't able to get quite enough space
and
to Gandhi shoot.
And Gandhi sends it out. Mitchell shoots, and he misses.
Yeah, just not quite there. Good look, though. Really good look for Mitchell. I'd say he hits more of those than he doesn't. I'd go right back to that later if I'm Kansas City.
All right, and now with the ball is Dean. Sends it to Cortez Mosley, and then now it's DeMonte Brown. And now Ngandu gets the ball. Raekwondas spins from his defender, passes it out to Andrews.
Three.
Ooh, just hits the rim. But Anderson with the hustle play, and Ngandu, Mukemba has the ball. Andrews passes, and it's a foul. Almost took out the cameraman there.
Unbelievable hustle from Anderson on that play. I mean, you try and tell me this is an exhibition game. When you see the effort like that, he's treating this like it's March Madness. Unbelievable effort there, diving for that ball, giving the Roos an extra possession. Doesn't end up turning into points, but that's the type of effort that as a head coach you look back on and you want your players to have. That's a role model. That's a model that you want everybody on that bench, everybody on that floor to follow.
So on the court, it's Ngandu. Got Condis Mitchell, Anderson Kopp, Alan Mukemba Jr., and Shamari Allen.
62-44 here, coming up on 9 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the second half.
Tristan Harper back in as well. Tristan Harper trying to push the ball in, trying to shoot, and it's a foul. Looks like it's...
I think they caught him for a travel down there, actually, Christian.
Oh, man. A travel for Langston.
They've had a few tonight.
Just a few. And again, the Roos got to take advantage of that. Shamari has the ball.
Well, like you noted, the Roos.
Shamari pushes in, sends it out. Anderson. Ooh.
They're going to call a foul there.
That's a foul on Cortez Mosley.
They have been very, very physical on Kopp in this second half after the amount of shots he was able to hit in that first half. How can you blame him? I mean, how he was shooting in that first half, you've got to put a hand up in his face. You've got to be physical. No good looks for him.
And that was a good pass to Anderson. I think
absolutely.
He was wide open. He almost had that shot.
Absolutely. That was a great pass. And Kopp's first free throw here goes up and is good. So 1-1 for Kansas City, but the first one's good, so he'll get a second.
Man, and again, this looks like it could be the starting five, but again, who knows?
No official word yet. Tonight we thought we might get a little bit of an insight on that as Kopp's second free throw rims in.
And it's 64-44 with 9 minutes left. And as Langston takes out the ball, that's Dean the guard. Guard out of Miami, Florida.
All right, and he's going to keep pushing the ball out. There you go. That's A.J. Rennie. Passes the ball out. Langston just passing the ball overall as Tristan Harper with the layup.
And a timeout by Langston immediately after.
And that was an easy-peasy Langston-peasy layup.
Yeah, again, they've had a few of those where they've just gotten really good looks. And that's what I've been saying with Langston all night, is get to the basket, make something happen. That's when they're at their best. They haven't shot the ball particularly well tonight, but when they have forced the issue and when they have gone into the paint, that's when they've been their best on offense.
All right, and as you see, Marvin Menzies talking to his coaches there, including Joe Esposito, who I had the chance to talk to, telling me a little bit about how he came to Kansas City. Fun fact, Coach Menzies called his wife and was like, hey, can Joe come and join the fun here? And after a great conversation with Coach Menzies, Joe Esposito comes on board. And he's a key guy here. He's someone who players and coaches alike are excited to have.
Yeah, and something Menzies noted on during his press conference to start the season was how important building a great staff to him was. And he's really spoke highly of the guys that he has.
Yeah, and again, and I see another guy here. I think that's Robert Edwards. I also had a little lunch with him during the media day. Director of operations, another great guy as well. He was working under Coach Menzies in Nevada, I believe. And again, something I appreciate about this coaching staff is they all have a connection to Menzies.
Yeah.
They're all not random people. They all have some kind of connection to.
And that helps. A background always does help. Familiarity is a big deal when it comes to staffs, when it comes to rosters, whatever you want to call it.
A very big deal. And it's like, looking here again, Kansas City
with the ball.
Kansas City with the ball, and they're doing a great job on offense. Let's see if they keep going. As McKemba gets it.
It was looking for a screen, couldn't quite get it. Nice job defensively, not allowing it.
And then Langston, Dean, trying to kick the ball. McKemba puts it up, but he just misses. Looks like it's a foul on Tristan Harper.
Yeah, appears to be a very late call.
Very late call, and he's going.
And he's fouled out of the game.
Oh my goodness, yeah.
That's his fifth foul.
Tristan Harper fouled out. As if you're Langston, you don't like that, but nonetheless, thank goodness this is an exhibition match.
And I don't believe that the foul was called on the shot because Anderson Kopp is shooting it. That might have been a technical foul.
Very well could be. Anderson lines up, shoots, and misses.
Off the back iron. Tough luck there. Menzies sends his best guy to the line, but just not able to sink it.
Again, not a big deal. This is a preseason game, but if you're Anderson, you want to make that shot. And it looks like it's Langston ball. Knox is going to take it out. Looks like he send it out to Dean. And again, Kansas City was showing some press, but they pulled back. Dean with the ball. He's looking. Knox moving around.
And nothing going for the Langston offense right now. Trying rolling to direct
with
traffic.
Rolling with the screen. And Dean tries to lay it up, but he just can't. And then there's a block, but Langston has the ball. That was a block by Ngandu. And then Shamari trying to play defense, and he does really good job getting to his face.
And just a missed three there that Langston probably thinks they should have had. But here comes a turnover. Back the other way comes Langston. Easy transition layup for Langston.
That was Toru Dean. Again, a guy that's making a difference here as well.
64-48, a little closer, tightening up a little bit here.
Just a little bit.
7:25 to play here in this game.
And there's Shamari passing the ball to Anderson. Anderson trying to take a shot.
And they're just not giving Anderson any room.
And Shamari with the turnaround, and he just misses. It's a great look. He had that little turnaround fadeaway. And here's A.J. Rainey with the ball. He's looking to find someone open. He sends it to Knox. Knox pulls in, and it's
another very late foul call. Knox went up for the shot. Did miss it. It wasn't a call for a while. We have a media timeout with 7:04 to go. The lead down to 64-48 for Kansas City. Langston has climbed back just a bit here in the second half. And like we mentioned, by that 5-minute mark, you want to be back to back about mid-10. And they have an opportunity to do that.
Yeah, Kansas City needs to play better defense here. 64-48, yeah, they're close to that. But then they can cut this. Again, Langston can cut the deficit down, but if you're Kansas City, you got to do a better job. You got to do a better job overall.
Yeah, 100%. Kansas City, this half, what they have done, what they didn't do in the first half, has had careless turnovers, more at least than the first half. Defensively, they played fine. They've done a solid job defensively, but in recent few minutes, they've gotten in trouble with the fouls. We're going to have to see how down the stretch they do. We've seen with Langston a little bit of foul trouble. With Kansas City, they're going to have to try and keep themselves out of it.
Looking at Coach Marvin Menzies, in his 13th coaching year, career record, 244-161, .602.
It's a winner.
Yeah, 60%.
It's a winner. I mean, he's been at UNLV. He's been at New Mexico State, San Diego State. Just no place this guy has not done it, and he's excited to come here and try and give Kansas City basketball something to remember.
And, you know, again, looking last year, season review, conference record 12-6, tied for third in the Summit League.
And very successful season last year, and they're just looking to build on it.
Yeah, you know, their tournament result, they lost to South Dakota in the qualifying round, I believe, 61-74. If you're, again, talking to Coach Menzies, he wants to go far. He thinks he has the team to go far enough in the Summit League to enter
absolutely
March Madness.
Of course he does, because he's got guys that have come back, like Anderson Kopp, who he knows have been there, have produced, and he expects them to produce again. And then, of course, the guys he's brought in, he's expecting big things out of them. It's one day at a time, right? We can't just expect it to all of a sudden happen, and I don't think he does either. But he understands this team has a lot of potential, and his expectations are high.
And then coming in is number 10, Precious Idiaru, freshman from Germany. His brother was getting some minutes as well, promise. And let's go back to Anderson for a little bit while Knox hits some free throws here. Last year, he was averaging about almost 23 minutes per game with 8.3 points per game, 3 rebounds, almost 1.5 assists, and 23 total steals. You're hoping to see those numbers significantly increase with the absence of Marvin Nesbitt, Evan Gilliard, and Josiah Alec, and even Arkell Lamar.
Langston hits the first free throw out of the timeout, 64-49, one more for them. Going to try and cut this to a 14-point game.
And they miss.
Unable to do that, but foul on Langston during the rebound.
And that was, that was number 32. That was Ngandu trying to get the rebound. Is that another tech?
Doesn't
It's
not a tech at this point, but they have entered the bonus.
Entered the bonus.
This is the single bonus. It's not the double bonus. It's a 1-1. Both teams are actually in the bonus already.
Already, that's crazy.
7 minutes and change to play.
64-49.
First free throw is good, so he'll get another.
Yeah, make that 65 now.
Yeah, 65 now. Absolutely.
Okay, and Ngandu again. Physical player making a difference here for the Roos as well. Everyone just making an overall difference. Is that 66-49?
Connects on both.
Yeah, hits both free throws. All right, Langston takes the ball out. That is A.J. Rainey again. Let's go. Just looking for someone. Looking for some guys. And it's another. Oh, this is not good.
I don't believe they called a foul. I believe they stopped play for injury here.
That is not good. A.J. Rainey. Holding his ankle.
Yeah, and they're just going to go ahead and inbound this ball. No foul on the play. 6:52 to play.
You can't lose a guy like A.J. Rainey, like you're saying.
Tough, man.
Yeah.
Such a key member for that team.
Langston taking it out. It's Tristan Harper. He's going to pass it out to Dean. Dean.
I've been impressed with Dean's ability to facilitate tonight.
Yeah, great job. Him and Rainey are a really good duo. And that's a three, and that's a three-pointer by Anthony White. It was a great look there for the Lions.
And Anthony White, like we mentioned at the top of the broadcast, dropped 22 points last game. He's a threat.
And there goes Shamari, passes it to Precious. Precious looking for someone. And
bad
he throws
pass.
It. That was a bad pass. Now Knox has the ball.
driving down the court, and he makes it, and it's an and one for Knox.
So all of a sudden, momentum swinging towards Langston. Everything seems to be going their way at this point.
It's 66-54. The Roos lead is being cut down by a whole lot this
And I believe Kansas
half.
City's going to go ahead and...
Yeah, looks like it's going to be a timeout for the Roos. Timeout Langston. I just bamboozled you. My bad.
I thought it was Kansas City as well. It seemed as if it was, but Langston with the timeout.
Yeah, and overall, I'm liking what I see here.
Yeah, I mean, look, this second half, Langston has fought back, and they have been insanely impressive on the offensive end, pressing the issue, really getting coast-to-coast quickly. And they've really drawn a lot of fouls because they've been more aggressive. The city's going to have to adjust. We talked about halftime. What would Langston do to adjust? And that's what they've done. They've gotten quicker, and they've just gotten to this point to where they've forced Kansas City into bad defensive situations.
I mean, right, and the Roos are going to come out of the timeout. And again, what would you do? Again, if you're the Roos, you gotta try to get some more points out there because, again, gotta keep the lead going.
Well, yeah, offensively, you've got to get better sets. You've got to get better looks. Credit Langston. They've played great defensively in the second half, but you've got to find a way to get better looks as the free throw is no good.
And Kansas, pure chaos, and Anderson comes out with the ball.
There, Kopp, nice job getting that ball. 66-54 here. Roos still clinging on to a good lead.
There's Ngandu. Looking for an open man. He turns around. He hits it. Oh, man, and he misses.
And yet another transition basket for Langston. The lead is down to 10 with 5:53.
And that was a slam dunk needed. They're down by 10, Langston. Langston crawling back from this 20, almost over 20-point lead. Now it's Mitchell with the ball. And they fall.
And they're going to call an offensive foul on Kansas City there. So things are going right
for Langston, but things are going wrong for Kansas City.
5:40 to play. This one far from over.
It is very much far from over.
We said, man, can you get this down to 10 by the 5-minute mark? And they've done that with some time to spare.
We manifested this, Jackson. We manifested.
I wouldn't go that far, Cristian. I wouldn't say manifestation, but
nonetheless. Langston trying to cut down the lead to single digits.
And it's just been too many easy points for Langston this half.
Ooh, and a fake and a shot from Anthony White. And it's a
That would have been a big one. Wide open three. That would have been a huge one to cut it to single digits.
And now Andrews has the ball. Looking to push it in, and it's a turnover by the Roos again.
Just another turnover. Just another mistake.
Another killer turnover. They got to do really well on defense here if they want to make up for that.
Floater is no good offensively. Rebound by
Langston. Harper.
Kick out for three. That three is just off.
Just off for Langston. And Anderson has the ball on the fast break. Shoots a three. And he makes it.
That is insane. That is one of the biggest sets. That's one of the biggest possessions we've seen in this game. What went from a potential three from Langston turns into a three for Kansas City. That's a 6-point swing.
Holy cannoli.
And Cristian, Kopp is gonna pop. That's what he does.
If there's one thing you gotta take from this,
Kopp will pop. Yep.
Kopp will pop.
He will
Kopp
pop.
Can.
He's been a huge difference maker tonight for Kansas City.
Again, my caramba. This is
4:52 to go, 69-56 Kansas City. A little more breathing room with that three-pointer.
Just a little more. And now here comes Tristan Harper. Now Langston coming out with some speed, aggressive here.
Mm-hmm.
And you see Coach Chris Wright just trying to tell his offense to move. AJ Rainey back in.
And he
what a block!
Immediately, they get the ball back, however. Passing it around, looking for a shot. Shot clock down to four and a great find into the paint. What a find. 69-58 Roos lead.
And here we go. Shamari's gotta make a play. If you're the Roos, you gotta make a play now.
Yeah, you wanna put them to bed here. You don't wanna get them any closer than they already are.
Alright, and here we go. Shamari throws it out to Raquandis. Raquandis fakes it. He pushes it in and they try to make a no-look pass.
Another turnover. The Roos are being killed by all of these turnovers. Here's a nice pass down
Tristan
low.
Tristan Harper fakes it, and he makes it.
Another score.
And now it's...
It's a nine-point game.
It's a nine-point game. Langston cuts it down to single digits.
This is the closest this game has been in the second half.
If you're the Roos, you got to call a timeout.
Timeout, Kansas City. We've got 3:42 to play. 69-60. Langston, got to give them credit. They are scrappy, and they are fighting their way back into this one.
If you're Kansas City, what are you doing here now? Because, again, you had a 20-point lead, and it cuts down to 69-60.
If I'm Marvin Menzies, I'm in that huddle right now, and my face is turning red by how hard I am screaming to cut the turnovers out. Man, it just feels like every other possession, Kansas City is gifting Langston the ball, and those turnovers are turning into easy points on the other end for Langston.
Again, Kansas City, you know, at one point, they had a 20-point lead. They even had a, let's see here, if I'm correct, their biggest lead was 28 points.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
And Langston just taking advantage of those scoring runs. You know,
it's just been so many mistakes by Kansas City.
Yeah, basketball's all about runs.
Runs,
so.
Momentum, and cannot emphasize it enough. You have to get shots up if you're Kansas City. So many possessions have ended this half because of turnover. You've got so many good shooters. You've got so many strong offensive players down low. You cannot lose these types of opportunities by turnovers.
And, you know, funny enough, I'm looking, once we get some updated stats, I'm looking at the turnovers for Kansas City. Most of them have been coming from guys like Shamari. And you just get, well, not even Shamari, it's Raquandis. And you got to cut those down if you really want to make a difference here.
Yeah, absolutely. Kansas City coming out of this timeout, I'd bet they're, if I had to guess, Marvin Menzies is going to have them focused and they're going to be crisp. Because right now, what they've been seeing is they have not been crisp at all this half with the basketball, turning it over, giving Langston just more chances than they need. And you're going to have to see how they come out of this. I would bet a few set plays. Let's get the adrenaline a little down. I know we're a little antsy right now. We've been, you know, not playing our best basketball. I would say here you're going to see Kansas City kind of cool it down a little bit and just try and chill.
All right, there you go. Coach Menzies in the huddle. Again, Menzies got to give some confidence to his guys. Inject some life into this. Try to extend the lead and get this game out of reach for Langston. It's a nine-point lead for the Roos.
And look, if you're the Roos, the clock is your best friend here, right? 3:42, you're up 9 points. This is a game you should win. You've got an advantage, a pretty sizable one still, regardless if it's single digits. You just need to calm down, get a few good possessions in a row, and try and put this one away.
Mr. Kimball with the ball.
And they ran a play immediately out of the
and
timeout.
And then Shamari.
But that is going to be a charge. It's going to be a charge. Langston's going to have possession with 3:34 to play.
And Shamari Allen coming in. Raquandis coming back in. Shamari's out.
It's a big call right there.
Oh, brother. And it looks like he had five fouls as well.
Tough. It's a tough way to foul out.
But nonetheless, you got to be happy what you saw from Shamari today. All right, Langston with the ball. Roland has it. Sends it back to A.J. Renzi.
Yeah, and if you're the Roos here, you have to find a way to get a stop. You cannot let this bleed anymore.
Cortez Mosley had the ball, and now it's back to Dean. Sends it to A.J. Renzi. Sends it back to Dean. Sends it to Renzi.
An illegal screen on Langston, so this will be headed Kansas City's direction.
Good job. Again, now
that just goes back to the effort of Anderson Kopp trying to get over the screen.
And you just got to take advantage of these last couple minutes. You got about 3 minutes left, 69-60. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
listening to Roo Radio.
You want to bleed this clock down as much as possible and then get a shot off at the end of the shot clock. Try and give Langston as little amount of time as possible.
Kemba sends the ball out to Andrews. Andrews frightened, and that's a foul.
And they're going to call a foul on Langston there. I thought perhaps they might call a jump ball there, but ends up being a foul.
Again, Anderson, you see him talking to the players. He's really, really showcasing his leadership here. Let's see if Anderson and company can get something going. At least make it 70. At least get it past 70.
Yeah, try and get yourself back up double digits here. That'd be a big deal with 2:50 to play.
Oh, here we go. The charity stripe, it's Andrews.
And there you go. Course, which is a big one because it was a 1-1.
It's a,
I guess not anymore. Now it's a double bonus. Excuse me.
Oh, man, these bonuses, man.
I think the players thought it was a single bonus because they started moving on the free throw.
All right, 70-60. Let's see if we can extend a lead. And he does, 71-60.
Two big ones there for Kansas City.
Two big buckets with 2:50 left on the clock. And there goes Dean. Dean's pushing it down. Tristan Harper has the ball, sends it back to Dean. Dean looking, gets a screen for Roland. Sends it back to Tristan Harper. And has a fadeaway shot, and he misses. What an air ball.
Misses everything. I mean, that's just a poor possession. If you're Langston, you fought your way back into this game. You fought so hard to get here.
And now Langston's going to press, obviously.
No choice.
You got no choice. You're down by 11. You got to do something now. As Raekwon just passes the ball to Mukemba. Send it to Anderson. Anderson shoots the three. It's in! Anderson is on fire tonight with another three-pointer to extend the lead 74-64.
Cobb is gonna pop. Guys. I know it's probably gotten annoying tonight by how many threes he's made, but he is just on fire. By far been the most efficient scorer for the Roos tonight, and a huge basket. Back-to-back huge possessions for the Roos. They have a 14-point advantage with 2:21 to play now.
I can hear the firefighters from here, man. Anderson's too hot right now.
He is cooking, man, and look, that's what they're gonna need out of him this season. They're gonna need him to step up and make some of those big-time shots. And look, obviously he's open via press, but even then, if I'm Langston, no chance am I leaving him that open from downtown.
All right. 74-60, 2:21 left on the clock. Kansas City needs to close it out here.
And now Langston, a key note here, no timeouts remaining.
Nope, and the Roos have one timeout left. So.
Which they might need for inbounding. You know, that's all we can, that always can be tricky. So
just
it's good to
case.
Have that in your back pocket.
Hey, it is just in case. All right. As you see Dean coming out.
A little confusion defensively for the Roos here.
Tristan has the ball.
Seems like they've got it patched up.
Oh, and they try to get a steal, but...
Charge!
That's a charging foul on Langston.
There's been a high volume of charges tonight, both sides.
So, that's Cortez Mosley on with the charging foul. And that's his fifth personal foul as well, I believe.
There's been a lot tonight. You know, there's been both teams have been very physical.
Surprisingly scrappy today, you know, for an exhibition match. But you love to see it, right?
This is an exhibition for these players, man. Don't tell them that. They want to win bad.
All right. Raekwondas Mitchell passing to Kemba. And Andrews. Anderson Cobb passes it. Mitchell has the ball.
And here you want to just drain the clock. Out of bounds. It's going to go to Langston. Turnover.
Lessons. Dos minutos. Dos minutos left for Langston to attempt any kind of comeback.
.57 left in this one.
All right. It's time for the Roos to press.
Yeah, they're going to have to get something going quickly.
Looks like they're playing zone D.
If you're Kansas City here, it's just no threes. You'll allow a two. Just do not allow the three ball.
And that's a shot.
No.
Send
great
it down.
Pass.
And, that is out of bounds.
Going the Roos direction.
And Tristan Harper touched the ball.
Minute 38 to play here in this one.
Drain that clock. Run the clock down.
You know, when this game got this.
And that's a steal. And that's a foul on Mukemba.
Can't have it.
That was an actual smart play by Dean.
I guarantee you this week in practice, what Marvin Menzies is going to harp on is the turnovers. Cannot have the amount of turnovers Kansas City has had tonight. Just will not win you many ball games, especially in Summit League play.
And you know, again, for the first time back out on the court, gotta be happy what you're seeing from the Roos. 74-60 with 1:36 left on the clock in the second half. Precious Iduraru comes in for Mukemba.
Langston at the charity stripe here, trying to get whatever they can. The first one rims out, but it is the double bonus.
Can we give a shout out real quick?
Who are we gonna give it to?
I'm gonna give a shout out to Steve Kraske.
Let's do it.
Our main guy. He's someone that just texted us today, listening to our game, and it's happy to see a guy like him enjoying our stream here.
And don't think this would be possible without him. So thank you, Kraske, and hope you're enjoying the telecast. 74-61, Roos lead, a minute and a half to play. Going to try and ice this one away.
Sends it to Iduraru. Anderson has the ball. He's trying to move around. Staring down the court. Just trying to find something. Anderson pushing in.
Oh, and beautiful find
down low!
Great! Layup by Raquandis. That will more than likely be the final dagger in this one. Roos lead by 15 with about a minute to play.
Great design play by Menzies.
Oh, beautiful. And a great find from Cobb.
Langston, I'm just trying to recover.
What?
1 minute left. Tristan Harper tries to hit the three and he misses. And Andrews gets the layup, and this is going to be a win for your Roos. What a game.
Yeah, just dribble this one out. Try and run as much clock as possible.
There
pop
you go,
up the court, and he's just going to try and dribble and pass. Shot clock at 19. No need to even put a shot up here if you're Kansas City. Timeout by Menzies and the Roos.
Substitution timeout.
Oh, some timeout.
Sam Martin coming in. And again, Coach Menzies doing an excellent job drawing up a play to...
Menzies has really had this team looking solid tonight and a lot of good offensive sets. And what do we talk about when they cut the lead to 9? I guarantee you Menzies is in there drawing some stuff up.
And they're double-teaming Anderson, and they're going to foul him.
Yeah, they're going to call a foul. Langston wanted a jump ball there, not able to get it. 34.6 seconds to go. Langston's going to head to the line. Or excuse me, Cobb is going to go to the line.
Another shout out I want to give is to Kansas City Athletics, specifically my guy, Jared Fox. Another guy that we could not do this without, you know.
Absolutely.
He's someone I've been working with for a very long time as a sports editor, and now, you know, happy to work with someone like him, and especially just working with Kansas City Athletics in general.
First free throw is good by Kopp. Adds on to just a monstrous night by him.
Got 24 points. Again, he averaged 8 last year, and to see him make 20, just get 24 points today, that's big. And now Demo coming in for Anderson. Anderson's going to take a much-needed break.
Yeah, Anderson's going to finish this one with 25 points, leading the Roos. Just awesome to see out of the senior.
And now if you're the Roos, you just got to make sure nothing bad happens. As Tristan Harper has the ball, he's pushing it in, and it's a layup, and it's good.
22.6 to play. The Roos will more than likely just try and dribble this one out. And
Sam just
finish this off.
Yeah, Sam's just going to let this one run out.
Langston, got to give a lot of credit to Langston. They really fought back in this second half. And I think Langston's in for a very successful season. They
ladies and gentlemen,
have a lot of heart.
Ladies and gentlemen, and everyone, every Kansas City Roo, your Roos have won 78-63 in an exhibition matchup against Langston.
Real good showing tonight, Christian. I was glad to see the way they played, and I'm glad they faced a little bit of adversity there late, seeing their lead get cut, and the way that they responded. Kansas City, a lot of room to improve, but a lot of good things you saw here tonight.
And now we're going to head to the postgame show. It's going to be Zayin Barnes.
Welcome to the KRoo postgame show brought to you by RooNews. I'm Zayin Barnes here with Imani Dyke. Just finished up first exhibition game, UMKC against Langston. UMKC pulls out with a win, 78-63. Imani, what are some of those takeaways from that second half that you saw?
This scoreline is definitely not a reflection of the way this second half was designed. I cannot lie. UMKC was very sloppy in the first 5 to 10 minutes of this second half. Three early turnovers led to six quick fast break points straight out of the gate by Langston. Langston this half did a great job actually of being able to step up that defensive intensity and force UMKC into a lot of careless turnovers, whether it was giving the ball away or just their defensive presence, setting screens, creating charges, blocks. Whatever it was, the energy was definitely there from Langston. The scoreline is definitely not reflective of how the second half went up. What are your takeaways on it?
I mean, I agree with you. I think UMKC, 16 turnovers in that second half alone. I mean, that and to Langston's 8. So it looks like, while still kind of sloppy, Langston did start to take care of the ball a little more than UMKC. Regardless of that, going off of what you said about, you know, energy and pace, I think Langston came out with a ton of energy, you know, on the bench, yelling chants, you know, communicating better. Came out with some early turnovers here right out of halftime. Looks like they had 3 turnovers in the first minute and a half of that first few minutes out of halftime. But so that led to 6 early points, and then Langston goes on, you know, cool little run. It was starting to look like you know, it was going to switch sides. You know, Langston got into the single digits within 69-60, but ultimately UMKC was able to come out on top. It seems like Langston kind of came back to that sloppy defense with that press, you know, tried to force more turnovers, but it seems like their forced turnovers came better naturally. After trying to force them with that press, you know, Anderson Cobb comes out, simple, quick threes. That transition three really, really shifted that energy. So I think that's where UMKC really killed it, was on the three-point line and then also on the free throw line, too. They were really aggressive that second half. You know, try to get to the line, try to draw fouls. You know, took like we said, you know, in the halftime show, turnovers. So it was really, you know, a careless game by both teams. But ultimately, UMKC was able to come out because of their pace and their energy.
Yeah,
so
for sure. And you did point out Cobb. He had a huge game, 25 points, and it looks like he might be very big for first year coach Menzies. To use, looks like a great shooter, great outside presence, creates quick offense for this team, and I definitely see Menzies using him to his advantage a lot throughout the season. Big game by Cobb.
Absolutely, 25 points, you know, and like we said, that halftime show, his leadership was noticeable. It was visible. You know, you could tell him picking up his guys, telling everybody, you know, hey, we got this. You know, slow down, control the pace. You know, this is our game. This is our court. And he was really ultimately, I think, the centerpiece of this game, honestly. Not just his scoring, not just his distribution, but the way he controlled the game, the way he kept everybody calm and composed. I really admire that from him. So,
and before this is over, we're going to have a big shout out to Langston. Big shout out to Langston. Their effort tonight, they put it all on the floor. We cannot overlook them.
Absolutely.
Little shout out to AJ Rainey, Tristan Harper, the guards. They did a great job. They were a lot of the reason why Langston's defensive intensity was where it's at. Anywhere on the court, you saw Rainey and Harper D up really well. And Toru Dean, number three, came in with some great offensive plays. Great player, so can't forget about Langston. Great effort by those guys out there tonight.
Yep, absolutely. Absolutely. So thank you for listening to
Hello everybody.
That's one of the photographers, one of the obnoxious photographers, Julia.
Yeah, we got
Julia Campos,
in,
you know. I'm trying to get my autograph
hectic,
and everything.
Getting a little hectic
trying
over
to get
here
my autograph
at the
and everything.
In.
Put it the other way. So this is out.
Like this?
Yeah.
Sweet.
There you go. And then put the mic to your mouth so I can hear you.
There you go.
Awesome.
Perfect. All right, you ready?
Yep.
All right, this is Marissa Leggio here. I am with Anderson Kopp. Anderson, great game tonight. Just want to start off by saying that. What was your mindset going into tonight's game?
Yeah, I think mindset was just on the defensive end. Coach Menzies talks and preaches about defense all the time, so I knew my shots were going to come. We have an unselfish team, so I knew that they were going to come. I just wanted to lock in on defense.
Yeah, awesome. Next question I wanted to ask, you are one of the only, or one of the few returning players. How did it feel to be back out here, but with a fairly new team?
It felt amazing. The crowd was there tonight, especially for an exhibition game. They showed out, and so we're going to need that continued support going into our next game on Monday, which is the regular season. But I was so pumped to get out here with this new team, new coaching staff. Love the staff, love the team. We're a really, really close team, so we worked a lot up until this point, and so it was good to put that product on the floor now.
Yeah, that's great to hear. So for your next game on Monday, what are you guys going to focus on after tonight's game? Defense was great. Towards the end, obviously, got a little close game, but you guys came back, pulled through. What are you guys going into next game looking
like? I mean, we had 27 turnovers, and most of them were in the second half.
Yep.
So taking care of the ball, handling pressure, I think that's going to be a huge emphasis going into this next couple of days of practice. So really taking care of the ball, being strong with the ball. We're going to get healthy, get all the guys. We got a day off tomorrow. So, yeah, we're going to take advantage.